I'm doing good, Rich. My advice to you is to enjoy some beers, because that's what we're going to do tonight. We're going to be doing a lot of cool stuff tonight. As always, there will be a pub quiz. We'll talk a bit more about that later in the stream. As Richard said, we're going to go through some fantastic beers. We've got some live entertainment for you. Well, I say live. It's entertainment. But it's music and comedy and maybe some fun things in between. There's going to be quite a bit of exclusive content in this one. We're going to be piloting for the first time ever a little idea that I've been working on. Again, something to look forward to later in the night. Yeah, I think that's pretty much all the housekeeping done. Rich?
Yeah. So, should we just dive into the first beer then?
I think we should dive in, yeah.
We'll at least let people know what it is. So the first beer of the night is, it's from Amundsen. And I think I had a can here somewhere, but seem to have mislaid it.
Da, 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 da. I
got it. Do you want to introduce this beer?
Yeah. Me and Richard both tried this kind of independently of tonight, and we were both really good fans.
Yeah.
Who isn't a big fan of a very juicy, hazy IPA? But, you know, we could talk about it, or we could let the brewers talk about it, and I think you'd rather hear the brewers say what they have to say. So let's roll that video of Amundsen.
Hi, I'm John. This is Shagger. I'm here to show you around Amundsen Brewery today. We're based here in Oslo, but thought we'd show you a little bit around the brew house, how everything works here. Follow us this way. So to start with, we have a 4,000 litre brew house. We installed this about 3.5 years ago. And on the left-hand side here, we have our fermenters. We've expanded quite a lot over the last few years, adding also some 12,000 litre tanks on the end, as you can see.
Let's take a walk up to the brew house. This is where the magic happens. Right now we're brewing a high gravity ultra pastry stout. We're currently boiling in our mash kettle. We've been boiling now for good on 6 odd hours. Over here,
you've got what's left in the larder tun, separating the sweet warts. We'll take all this,
send it to our whirlpool later on. We'll knock out and send it into one of these fermenters. John, should we take him over?
See the rest of the brewery? This area here is where we store all of our raw materials, our malts, things like that. We also have our base malt, which comes in large silos. It's also where we keep our small African packing boy. Through there we have our cool room, and we also have stocks of empty cans, boxes, and all the other things we're going to need in the production process.
You take a look with us over here, you'll see
a whole range of core range product. Printed cans, we got everyday Hero, Ink and Dagger, Hot Liminal Messages, Runs of the Pills, and a few that are stored elsewhere.
It might be worth taking a peek into our cold store, where we send all of our packaged beer immediately after it leaves the canning line. See what kind of goodies we'll find in there.
Keeping the hops cold also means they last longer, taste better when we get them into the beer. And then also, the beer that is then ready is all stored in here, kept to a nice chill 4 degrees, so it's ready when it comes to you, as fresh as possible. This is where you want to be when the zombie apocalypse comes. Illusions of Funk, which I believe is the beer you guys are going to be drinking. Matthew will tell you a little bit more about this one.
Illusions of Funk is a hazy beer from Amundsen Brewery. Packed with malted wheat, oats, and then dry hopped heavily with Strata, Simcoe, and Mosaic. Juice bomb, overripe mango, dank, and delicious.
Cheers, man. Me and Chaga, that's everything. Don't.
Enjoy, guys.
So, apparently, you couldn't hear anything I just said. My mum texted me to say, nice blazer, can't hear a word you're saying. So, apologies for that, first off. I'm Richard Crosdale, editor of Ferment. My colleague in the other room is Beer 52 legend Doug Garry. Welcome to Cyberfest all over again. I guess you've kind of had your introduction from Amundsen now. This beer, I hope you're drinking it at home, is jolly good. I would say. Doug?
Yeah, we have to say one thing before we continue on though, Rich. There is another apology that you do need to make.
Because there are so many.
I put out a lovely Cyberfest 3 glass for you. And look at what you're doing.
I'm trying to make this my thing, Doug. I'm trying to make this my trademark move.
It's not a good look, man.
Swigging glass out of the... If I was allowed to bring a brown paper bag, I would. All right, okay, I'm getting the glass now. You can't see this, but everyone at home can. Yeah.
But yeah, we have more entertainment coming up for tonight. Once again, welcome to Cyberfest 3, and apologies for the sound issues earlier. Up next, we do have the first bit of non-beer related entertainment. Rich, before we get into that though, how have you been doing? Because I haven't seen you since June.
Yeah, no, I'm really good. I'm just back from a whole week up in the Highlands, been to Harris and Skye and sort of all along the West Coast. So I'm feeling, my legs are really sore. I am covered in midge bites. If I were to show you my legs, they look like Nick. Do you remember knickknacks?
I do remember knickknacks.
Yeah, my legs look like just like horrible blistered knickknacks at the moment.
To kick off
you are welcome, everyone. but other than that, I'm a happy man. How about you?
sure we're returning to the old normal, not the new normal. But yeah, still working from home, everyone's doing kind of social distancing. Some of us have come back to the office, some of us have stayed at home. Yeah, still a bit weird though, I have to say. I don't know about anyone at home, but I do feel like we are in that kind of limbo state, that liminal space in between, you know, completely locked down and going to the pub.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, going back to the pub's really been certainly for a lot of us has been the big thing over the last month or so, and sort of getting used to, all right, it's the pub, but it's not quite the pub as we know it. But also, you know, really wanting to support your local. And it's something we've written about in the magazine quite a lot, and that I think for a lot of people in the beer community, that's really been the sort of biggest manifestation of life returning to normal a little bit.
And I mean, some people have been really busy during lockdown as well. You know, apart from just working at home, or you know, if you're a frontline worker or a key worker, you've obviously been run off your feet trying to keep the country afloat. Big thanks to all you guys there.
Those guys have had enough thanks.
I'm going to say it again, Rich. I don't care who knows it. I'm thankful to the key workers. They're good people. They're good eggs. But yeah, we've also seen, you know, some amazing like responses to the lockdown in terms of art and in terms of community building as well. I've seen there's this wonderful thing that like kids arts charities have started doing, where like they make these painted rocks and they lay them out in kind of like a snake pattern, or like they'll like just tie ribbons on railings just to do something to liven up the place when they go out on their kind of socially distanced walks. It's so beautiful to see. And speaking of beautiful things that have happened during lockdown, we do have the first bit of non-beer related entertainment for you guys, and it is Wilds and the Hackney Colliery Band doing a social distanced music video for us. So let's check that out just now.
Brilliant.
Hi everyone at Cyberfest, my name is Wilds. Thank you so much for having us at your online beer festival. Stay safe and happy drinking.
Take me out for a night. We can wait and see. You're so scared to have faith in the world, but I wanna make you believe in true love.
fantastic stuff. Delightful. Thank you very much to Wilds and the Hackney Colliery Band. It just goes to show what you can do with a bit of social distancing and a drone, and I think some a lot of musical talent. Yeah, thank you so much, guys. We're going to see some more entertainment, some more music coming up later in the night. But for just now, I did want to mention that you know, we have been drinking the Amundsen Illusions of Funk, and it's a really lovely beer. Mm. Rich, I don't know about you, but I'm enjoying the beer.
Yeah, I'm happy. Yeah, I'm happy we picked this one to stick with. First off the bat, it's lovely. It's you know, it's everything you want from a hazy IPA. It's really kind of typical of what Amundsen have become famous for, which is the sort of massive flavours, big juice bomb.
Yeah.
But it's also got a lot of really lovely sort of resinous, piney, kind of grassy quality to the hops as well, and a nice little snap of bitterness at the end, which yeah. a lot of these sort of super hazy IPAs kind of yeah. lack. I think it's a bit more rounded than some of them. So well done, Amundsen, and yeah. thank you.
Yeah, and also you know, let's talk about the can design, because that's funky. I think there's no other word for it. It's definitely like a funky can design. I'm a sucker for a good label, Rich. I have to say, like, it's part of what I, you know, craft beer is like, what attracts me to some craft beers.
Yeah.
It's a good label. If it's good aesthetics, I'm more likely to kind of look at it.
So. It's got to stand out, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. And this definitely stands out with its kind of holographic elements to the label and everything. But yeah, as you say, it's a juice bomb with just a nice little hint of bitterness at the end. Really kind of balances it out.
Yeah.
But coming up, we have another fantastic beer from Tempest Brewery.
Yes.
And we also have the first question of our Cyberfest pub quiz. Ta-da! So for those of you who have been to a Cyberfest before, you'll know how this works. For those of you who haven't, here's the lowdown on the pub quiz. Basically, what we're going to do throughout the night is we're going to play some quiz questions. If you think you know the answer while the brewery video is playing, all you need to do is email the answer to cyberfest@beer52.com.
That's email it. Don't add it to the YouTube comments.
Yeah.
Email it to us and we will pick a winner. And well, we won't pick it. The fates will pick it. Destiny will pick a winner.
Destiny is all. But yeah, if you do want to make a comment about the night, you know, if you're enjoying a particular beer or you want us to see what kind of home bar setup you've got going, you can tweet us at beer52hq with the hashtag Cyberfest3.
Send pictures.
Yeah, send us pictures. We love seeing kind of what you guys are doing at home to celebrate Cyberfest. Like,
genuinely.
Yeah, it's genuinely one of the best bits about doing this. But for now, we have a pub quiz question and a video from Tempest Brewing.
Enjoy.
Hi, this is Billy D here. In Star Wars, what is my character Lando's full name? In Star Wars, what is my character Lando's full name?
Yes, beautiful people, welcome to Cyberfest, put on by those angels, Beer 52, without which we won't be enjoying these succulent ales, and especially this mango Berliner Weiss, the dream. You don't have to die to go to heaven. You just have to suck down one of these bad boys. Right, that was a great start. Let's keep going and see the brewery. So every day begins about the same. I wake up with a single tear rolling down my face because I'm so lucky to work at Tempest Brewing Company. Started in 2010 by Gavin and Annika. Originally through in Kelso, which is probably a town that no one's heard of, but in a small little dairy facility that was not suited for brewing whatsoever. They moved to this big place in 2014, but I like to think the company didn't really get going until I joined in 2017. I really hope my boss isn't watching because he's got such a... doesn't matter. Oh gosh, I can't do it. Right, let's go this way. I'm gonna get my Keith Floyd on just now. So, in absentia of a new brewery, we decided to buy lots of nice new equipment. So, ostensibly, over to the side, which I don't pan to Neil because I don't want to be able to see it. Oh, I said, don't pan, darling. It's a complete disaster right there. So we've got an excellent silo that is our delivery system for our base malt, which as everyone perhaps knows is that the base malt, the malt bill of a beer is comprised of two parts. You have your base, which is very little in the way of color and flavor, and then all your adjunct and stuff. But for this beer, I suppose that's perhaps 60% base and 30% wheat, just for that mic, just to be true to style. Then down into our mill room, around the back. But again, do not pan, I'm begging you not to pan. I've been on holiday for 2 days, and the place is a complete disaster. Right, Then our mash down here, which you can look at because I'm rather proud of this big girl. So essentially just a giant porridge pot. This is where we hydrate the mash for up to an hour to break down all that sweet, sweet starch hidden in the endosperm of the malt. We mash it for an hour, then we recirc it through itself to clarify it. We bash it into the boiler in the end, which you perhaps can show to there. Yes, the dream. And that's where we boil the sucker up. But it's also where we do our kettle souring for this particular beer. So we get up to the boil just for a bit to make sure that it's not got anything horrible growing in it, because the sugar and carbohydrate and malt is not only an energy source for the yeast to turn into booze, lucky for us, but it's also home. It could also be the sustenance for any number of bad mothers, you know. Try not to swear here, because I do get quite animated when I'm giving a tour. So we boil it for a bit just to make sure that there's no microbiological contamination available. Then we cool it down to our heat exchanger to bring it to 45 degrees or thereabouts. Then we use our souring method, which could be one or two things, but I can't remember what I'm going to do this now. We do that with tandem and a bit of lactic, and then we let it sit for the course of about 12 hours. And in the morning, you have to rush in with a look in your face, you don't know what's going to be happening. And it could be a million of points away, or it could be right on the money. And I remember Emmanuel Berliner being a good chap and being right on the money. So we're looking for that pH to come down. You start off with thereabouts of like 5, and you're looking to hit like 3.6, 3.5, just to get that nice like, bit of sourness on the edge of it. And it's important because to get in a bit early to make sure that it's not run away with itself, because if you start trying to put out a beer at 2.89, it might come back pretty quickly, I would have thought. So we boil it again to stop the souring process. We chuck in a bit of a Whirlpool Edition hops, or was it Whirlpool Edition? Or was it Cold Side? Either way, it's a Zacka, which maybe that's a trade secret I shouldn't be giving away unless it's written on the can. Let's double check. Ooh, just a very nice blurb about Bowie, but I don't see anything about a Zacka, so we might take that bit out. Maybe you could beep it when we go. That's known for, it's like a sort of mango hit. I mean, a lot of hops speak to like tropical fruits and things of that nature, but mango is definitely a big Zacka player. So then we ferment it cold, of course. I think we usually reserve our indoor tanks for ale because we just like slam it out, you know, it enjoys the quick, fast maturation. Conversely, this had a good old time. And then it was in can, which is fantastic because, well, we've just got a canning machine. Yes, I've just been informed that I made no mention at all of the mangoes that go into Mango Berliner. And, you know, I was very upfront of this. I'm not a TV personality yet. So let's get into the mango side of things. Ha, yes. A little bit of love. Look at that. You can't plan that, man. Does that look like a love heart? It's hard to tell on this side. That looks like a love heart. Right, anyway, it speaks to all the love that goes into this beer. A lot of love, a lot of tears, and a fuckload of mango. We can beep that bit out as well. That'll be fine. So what we do is, and anyone will tell you, the pitching of fruit into beer is always a nightmare. You have to make sure it's completely aseptic. There's no chance of anything mental happening in your FB because you've committed all this time and work to it. You usually have to introduce it with some sort of mental delivery system. So we have a modified keg with the CO2 purging capabilities. That way, because the yeast is practically dormant at this point and not scavenging off oxygen, which everyone knows is a complete enemy to beer, you may have enjoyed some at your local. In fact, I'm not going to slag anyone else. That's probably the number one thing. The number one takeaway is that I've committed no libel in this video. Come to my tour, though. Wait until I've had a couple of beers, then we can talk about that. Yes, and then so we wait until just about the little towards the end of fermentation, and we pitch it in. I think for this particular beer, it was like 300 liters of mango puree. I mean, this obviously is an idea born out of the marketing department. Unless you're Vault City, those guys are nuts. The stuff they do is absolutely crazy. And that's not libel, because that's a compliment, if anything. So then the yeast enjoys like a little bit of re-fermentation, which you'll notice in your bubbling bucket. And the lesson we've learned from doing work with fruit, I feel, is ensuring you get like a nice fruit pitch, hot and cold side. Because if you do it hot side, you get that like real depth of flavor, you know, like it's completely incorporated into the wort, be that like nice zest or puree perhaps, but usually zest. And that way, it's present already in the wort. And then when you come to pitching cold side, you're just trying to achieve that nice like top note, you know? And I feel like if you sort of like sacrifice one or the other, you might find that you're not going to hit the right marks. But as it stands, I think this is a banger. I mean, typically we do a lot of like fruity, sour stuff in the summer, as is everyone. And it's quite fun because we're doing a lot of stouts at the moment, like a lot of stouts. A lot of early mornings for Big Hodge and 1300 kg mashing in, which takes a real toll on your emotional well-being as well as your relationships and things of that nature. But every brewer knows that. apologies for not mentioning this in the first instance. I'll do better next time. Can't wait to see you next year at next year's Summerfest. Thank you. And wait 1 second. A little off-screen magic here. And good night. Oh, thank God. Right, that's a wrap.
In Star Wars, what is my character Lando's full name? Mandonis Balthazar Calrissian.
Thanks again to Tempest for sending in the video and for sending in their beer. If you're drinking along at home, I do hope you enjoy their beer. It's fantastic.
Local legends as well, Doug. They're not too far from us, so we get down to see them whenever we can. They're really, really cool guys.
Absolutely. And for those of the keen-eyed among you at home may have noticed that the beer running order, it kind of runs in my sort of dream road trip for this selection of beers. So we've started in Norway, we've moved down to Scotland, we're going to move into England next, and then we're going to go down into Ireland, a bit more of England, and then over into continental Europe. So for those of you playing along at home and want to plan out a good road trip, follow the beers. That's my advice to you. That's Guru Doug's advice.
But more advice. You should be charging for this.
I should be charging. Well, you know, they paid for a box. I feel like this is part of the service now.
First one's always free.
Absolutely. The next one's going to cost you. For those of you who are drinking along and feel like you really want to show your appreciation for the beer that you're drinking, if you find an absolute standout, a cracker, your favorite beer, then all you need to do is head to our Twitter at Beer52HQ. We do have, for the first time in Cyberfest history, we do have a live poll going on over there where you can vote for your favorite beer of the night, and we'll announce the winner live at the end of the evening. So
because we just wanted to make things slightly more complicated for ourselves.
Absolutely. So yeah, if you've got a beer that you are really enjoying and you want to see it win that coveted, mostly just ceremonial title of best beer of Cyberfest 3.
Entirely ceremonial, Doug. Just be very clear.
Then please do head over to at Beer52HQ and vote for your favorite beer.
Show it some love.
But next up, we do have another brewery video, Rich.
Yes, indeed. Full circle from your hometown, I believe, Doug.
Land of my, well, not father's, because...
Just, I mean, yeah. Your father.
Father.
Yeah, land of your father, where he went to work. Yes. Full circle. Really, really cool, really interesting brewery. They're one of these guys that sort of came out from nothing, like, I think it's just even just a little over a year ago, and have absolutely kind of exploded onto the scene with these, like, really, their design's fantastic. Their beers are all, like, total crowd pleasers. Brewed brilliantly, and we've been really impressed with them. The one that's in the box, Looper, is a really good example of that. It's very soft, very dangerously drinkable. It's all sort of citrus fruit with a little bit of kind of grapefruit at the end. Very low bitterness. So if you want a sweet tropical hazy IPA, Tall Boy, you know, drink it in the sunshine. Don't drink it now. Drink it in the sunshine. Would be my advice. So we have a video, do we?
Yep, we do.
Yes, we do. All right, let's watch the video.
Not many people get this opportunity, but we are lucky to be here with Cyberfest. Uh-huh. you'll see all the action. What's going on? Come with me. With me. Fantastic brewery. We're so excited that they've let us do this and we can't wait to get in. And that's Cyberfest at Full Circle Brew Co. Cyberfest, we are back in the tap room of Full Circle. About to try a delicious beer, but first I'm going to give you the boring introduction. No, it's exciting. It's exciting. We've got the owner of Full Circle, Ben Cleary, and we've got head brewer, Alex Redpath. They're going to take us through a little bit about the beer we're going to taste. Full Circle Looper IPA. They call it their signature IPA of their core range. So let's get right into it. Ben, I'm going to ask you a little bit. Looking at this can design, it's very different compared to a lot of the breweries out there with the feel, the look. Just take us through why, what went through your mind for this can design?
That's right, so it's about 2,500 breweries in the UK. We wanted to differentiate ourselves from the others, and we went for boldly simple. You look at the Coca-Cola design, they've never changed their design in 50 years. So we went for boldly simple, but when you do come up close, you've got a little bit of tactile varnish, which reflects where we're from, which is the Quayside in Newcastle. So that's why we went down that route.
Lots of people always want to know what's in the beer, what am I drinking? So what goes into Looper to make it what it is?
Yeah, I'll be quick so I don't bore you all. But on water, it's a very kind of soft profile, almost version of New England. Yeast is a London yeast. Malt, you're looking at extra pale, wheat, oats, and a very, very tiny bit of crystal in terms of Karagold. And then the big hitters are the hops, which are Citroen Mosaic and Cashmere.
Citroen Mosaic and Cashmere. Not okay. So, we'll go into a little bit of what might those hops do for the beer, what you might get out of them, but let's crack this open. Let's give it a go.
Good idea.
Signature IPA, so... I'm thirsty, so let's crack this
out.
Let's
crack it this time.
Yeah, let's do it.
First beer of the day.
First time. Let's crack it, I guess.
You can still talk about the can design.
We've got some guests coming in. We've got some guests coming into the tap room.
Best pour of the day, this one.
Gotta tilt that glass.
So far, so good.
Oh, Tom has given a little extra foam at the top.
But you've done it to the brim,
professional bro.
That was really good. Good pours. Obviously, like, holding this glass up, I can't see through it at all. Like, well, why the haze craze?
Yeah, it's unfiltered, it's unfined, all the flavors kept in there. There are some adjuncts in there. Wheat and oats, which help give it its mouthfeel and its body, but we're not going to find this, we're not going to try and make it bright, it drops our flavour. This is kind of exactly what I love to drink, and that's why it's this hazy, and the colour is pretty much down to the extra pale and a tiny bit of crystal in there.
So, obviously we see the side of the beer, let's give it a bit of a sniff. Let's see what we can get out of the aroma. And you know what? When you feel like that glass a little too full, get a little on the smell.
Wow.
You really got your nose in there now. So what are you picking up?
That's a very professional technique there.
The quick dip.
it adds to the flavor. So what I'm hoping people get out of it is a lot of citrus. specifically lemon and lime, a bit of grapefruit zest, or just grapefruit in general, maybe even a hint of tangerine at the back. That's what I get on the nose anyway. Tom? Bubblegum?
I mean, I read that you can get a little bubblegum off cashmere or mosaic.
One of the three.
I did a little bit of research, but my notes are gone. So if you're getting a little bubblegum, don't think you're crazy. But yeah, let's go in, let's dive in, let's have a sip. Let's get the full flavor, let's get the full effect.
It's a big shake.
Alex is over 6 feet tall, so his sips are like our chugs. Just talk us through what we might be getting in the taste buds.
Yeah, of course. I mean, I'd start with just a very soft marker. So we've gone with a kind of New England style wort profile on there, which makes it very soft and smooth bitters on that. Quite a nice body, so that's where the wheat and the oats come in. And then you're looking at the hop profile on top of that, which is kind of citrusy, tangerine-y, bit of grapefruit pith. It's quite a nice, well-rounded beer.
No. Take five.
Too big for me. They have schooners over there, don't they?
Yeah. I'm getting a lot of grapefruit through that. Cyberfest, we really hope you enjoyed having a beer with us at Full Circle with Ben Cleary, Alex Redpath, and me, Tom Maroon. Enjoy the Looper, enjoy the rest of Cyberfest, and we hope to see you guys drinking more Full Circle beers in the future.
Yeah, please come visit us. Cheers. Cheers.
Looper Bowl! Looper Bowl. Why Looper Bowl?
Thank you very much, Full Circle. I hope anyone who's opened that can just now is thoroughly enjoying it. We have some shout-outs next. This is a fun thing that we're going to be doing all evening. So if you want a shout-out, email or Twitter us on the links provided. Our first couple, George Roberts, wants to shout out to his other half, Nicole. They were going to get married this year, but had to cancel. I hope that's postponed rather than cancel, because otherwise that's... It's a bit awkward, isn't it? Yeah, the venue were fine, just wasn't really into it. Lizzie Forbush? Yep. Has bought all three Cyberfests for her husband, and he always tries to get her a shout out. But Lizzie and Tyler are teachers, so definitely deserve a shout out.
Absolutely.
So shout out to you guys. One of the weirdest things about lockdown for us in Edinburgh has been, of course, the cancellation of the world famous Edinburgh Fringe Festival and the International Arts Festival, which has been it's been a real blow, hasn't it, Doug?
It has been. It's a historic moment. The Fringe has been a constant, ever since I moved to Edinburgh. It's a thing that takes over the city. I don't know if you can really understand that unless you've been here during August, but there's so many festivals going on all at the same time that just the city becomes a completely different beast. You're surrounded by tourists and people asking you where the castle is and where the show is, and flyers upon flyers upon flyers.
And of course, we've both been on the other side of that.
Yeah,
we've been those annoying bastards pushing flyers on people who are just trying to get to work.
Yeah, I'm there to sell quality entertainment. That's what I was doing. Don't know about you, Rich.
Not so much. it's been really strange. Of course, one of the parts of the country, one of the industries that's really suffered during coronavirus has been the arts.
Yeah.
Theatres, cinema. It's been really tough for a lot of people out there, and I think that does kind of tend to get forgotten. So we've Doug, you've been doing some work with the King's Theatre, haven't you?
Yes, we have. You know, I was really missing those kind of niche fringe shows that you used to see, or those niche films that you used to watch. You know, just the weird concept, the truly bizarre idea that you think, why did someone think of this? Okay, let's go see what it's about.
You can just tell us that it's that stuff that somebody spent like years obsessing over and kind of refining it over and over in their head, and it only makes sense to them, and to everyone else, it just looks like just this completely bizarre, random, like, totally nonsensical piece of crap. You know the kind of thing I'm talking about.
I know exactly what you're talking about, and I refuse to apologize. And with on that note, please roll the tape.
Oh, fuck.
Nous découvrons un homme. Il est grand, il a 38 ans, et il ne parle pas français. Il attend. Oh, il attend pour une bière. Avec un verre vide. Depuis combien de temps ? Ces bières sont arrivées 4 semaines auparavant. 4 semaines. 28 jours. 672 heures. Le temps semble s'étendre sans fin. Il est un homme nouveau, se délectant de sa bière. La vie est simple, douce. Son cœur, tel une rose en fleur. Il ne le sait pas encore. Tout va s'arrêter. Comme vous et moi, les bières partent en fumée. Le verre se vide.
So empty.
Dépourvu de bière.
Where did it all go?
N'ayant rien vu de plus que les murs de son appartement depuis si longtemps, il n'est même plus sûr que le monde existe encore. Maintenant, il se sent obligé d'essayer. D'essayer et de remplir ce verre vide. Reçu le courrier de suivi la nuit dernière. Mais maintenant, il doit attendre. Encore une fois ? Mais l'homme est espiègle, car celui-ci s'est inscrit à Beer 52. Et il dispose maintenant d'une collection de bières artisanales pour son plus grand plaisir. D'un verre vide, nous avons maintenant un verre plein. La peur de l'existentialisme se fane dans les concepts obscurs de pensées lointaines, fugaces et emportées par la brise. Il boit une bière, le verre n'est plus vide. mais ils ne parlent toujours pas français.
Thanks again to the King's Theatre in Edinburgh and Capital Theatres. As you may have seen, they do have a Just Giving. Please do consider donating. It's also, the link for it is in the description, but it is www.justgiving.org/Capital Theatres. They were fantastic to work with. They were very accommodating and for the silliness. And they also wanted everyone to know that, you know, they do have hope for the future. They will be full again, as we said at the start of the video. So big thanks to them, and please do give if you can. Also, I feel like I need to just bring up the fact that the mics were still on just towards the end of the last live segment. Joys of live streaming there. If someone can make me a meme of Rich saying what he said, you'll get a special thank you from yours truly, because it's a beautiful moment in hindsight. We do have a pub quiz winner, the first one of the night. Of course, the answer to the question, what is Lando's full name in Star Wars, is Landonis Balthazar Calrissian. So anyone looking for baby names, there's three good ones right there. And the winner is Martin, I'm going to butcher your surname, Martin, but it's Buchan? Buchan?
Feels like Buchan.
Feels like Buchan, spelt like Buchan. Martin, well done. We'll be in touch to get you your case of beer for winning that pub quiz question. Of course, there are plenty more opportunities to win some beers in the pub quiz. All you got to do is email those quiz answers to cyberfest@beer52.com. That's cyberfest@beer52.com. And we have plenty more entertainment alongside that as well, including, brace yourselves, a live tasting of one of the beers for tonight that's going to be led by Rich. So we're going to do that for Galway Bay's Red Ale. So if you want to take part in the live tasting, put that beer to one side. We're going to be coming to that very shortly. But first, Rich, we do have another brewery video, I believe.
Yes, Brew York, fantastic brewery. They can do no wrong in my eyes. They are a really excellent craft brewery within the historical medieval walls of York itself. If you've never been to York, it's great. There's a transport museum, there's the Jorvik Viking Centre, and there is Brew York and their wonderful, wonderful tap room. So let's watch that video.
Hi there. Doug asked me to ask a question for this quiz that you're having, the cyber quiz. I would love to join this club. It's a quiz supporting breweries. Oh, that's a wonderful cause. I'd love to be involved in. Anyway, here is the question. What events were the inspiration for the Red Wedding in Game of Thrones?
Do that again.
So,
Hello guys, welcome to Cyberfest 3. I hope you're all enjoying the festival. So I am Lee Grabham. I am the owner, co-founder and head brewer of Brew York Brewery, which is in the historic city of York. I'm currently sat in our beer garden. We have a riverside beer garden. That is the River Foss just to my right there. And if you were to pan over that way, you would see a beautiful building called Roundtree Wharf, which is part of the city's chocolate heritage. So Brew York was founded back in 2006 by myself and Wayne Smith. We were both keen amateur brewers, brewing in each other's back gardens in a couple of sheds. So fairly familiar story in the industry these days. Eventually we were made redundant from our respective careers, and we turned that conversation that we had down the pub many times into what we now know as Brew York. So that was about 4 and a bit years ago. We've changed our core range many times over that period. One of the more recent additions to the core range is this beer here, which we call Karma Chameleon. You can kind of guess where we got that one from. So it's an APA, an American Pale Ale, so designed to have kind of a low level of bitterness, relatively easy drinking. It's not designed to be like all these kind of mega juice bombs you get these days. You can see in there is some hop haze, but it's not completely opaque like you get with some of them. Because it's got a more of a classic malt bill, and we don't use massive amounts of oats and wheat. So the hops that we've used in this particular beer is Columbus to give us a little bit of juice, tiny bit of citrus, a little bit of pine, and we've also used Simcoe, which gives us a nice kind of big resinous character. Alongside that, we've used a good amount of Idaho 7, one of the more modern hops out there now, and we've used Mosaic, which gives us beautiful bubblegum character. So let's have a little taste. Yeah. It's not intended to be the big soft juicy things that are all the rage these days. Absolutely going for the classic profile with this one. So you can see on the can we have Colin, our Karma Chameleon, and you'll see that the colour scheme is red, gold and green. The astute of you will realise that comes from the lyrics of the song. Yeah. This is one of mine and the brewer's go-to beers right now. I think at the start of any session, the one of the beers you're going to find me on is either this or probably Juice Foresight. It's just really accessible, really easy drinking. Beautiful thing to start your session on. So I hope you're drinking this towards the start of your Cyberfest with that said. So enjoy the festival, guys. See you again soon. Today you find me sat in our Riverside Beer Garden. So the brewery was established in 2016. One of the things that first attracted us to this. Feel that burping?
Yeah. Yeah.
The wife's name, Holly.
Throw your hands up like a cowboy as well.
What events were the inspiration for the Red Wedding in Game of Thrones? The answer is the Black Dinner and the Glencoe Massacre. Good luck. Bye-bye.
And a big thank you to Brew York. Make sure you keep getting your answers in for the pub quiz question. Again, the answers go to cyberfest@beer52.com. And don't forget, if you want a shout out during the night, you can tweet us your shout out. You can email us at cyberfest@beer52.com. If you do tweet us, use the hashtag Cyberfest3 just to make sure that we see it. Coming up, we have the live tasting of Galway Bay's Bay Red Ale. But first, we're going to do a quick pub quiz question. So fingers on buzzers, email, keyboards, phone screens, I don't know what you're using, but get ready to answer the next question, which is coming up just now.
Hi guys, the question is, how many points did Liverpool accumulate before the postponement of the 2019-2020 season? How many points did Liverpool accumulate before the postponement of the 2019-2020 season?
Fantastic. And we are back for the live tasting. Those of you drinking along at home, I've poured out mine already. Please feel free to start pouring your glass. But Rich, you're going to take us through some of the key points about this beer.
Yeah, sure. So this is an Irish Red Ale from Galway Bay. It's a really, really nice brewery. They have a lovely, lovely, lovely bar called Northern Lights, which I got horrendously drunk in last year, but in a good way, in a socially responsible way. So this is this is their Bay Ale, Irish Red Ale. I'm just going to pour a little bit of that. It's pretty lively. A lot of bubbles. There was a certain amount of pressure doing this in front of however many hundred people, because
I don't think people understand how weird it is to just like do a beer tasting / just talk in general to just a camera.
I wasn't even talking about the talking. I was literally trying to pour a competent glass of beer, and I've ended up with something that I just want to stick a flake in it, to be honest.
You're being judged, Rich.
I'm my own harshest critic, Doug. Apart from you, obviously. it's a pretty classic red ale, really. There's a lot, huge amounts of malt on the nose. It's really nice and bready. You can smell the some lovely sort of biscuity crystal malt in there. I think they use Munich as well, but there's also some slightly roasted malt as well, which gives it just a little tiny bit of coffee bitterness, but it's more sort of round and chocolatey than that. The hops don't jump out on the nose, but let's have a wee taste.
Well, that is nice. I do like that.
It's lovely. It's really it's really well balanced. The first thing is that sort of wash of warm, round, comforting, bready, slightly sort of chocolatey malt, which is exactly as you'd expect. And the colour's fantastic as well. I don't know if you can see that with this sort of fancy studio lighting that we've got, but it's an absolutely gorgeous colour. It just looks like a hug. And then the hops come in. It's quite old school in the sense that there's not a huge amount of sort of aromatic hop character. It just gives that really sort of nice astringent bitterness at the end, which combined with the sort of slightly sort of savoury, salty character of it, just has you, my mouth's watering even as I'm talking, but it just keeps you like reaching for your glass. It's a very Moorish beer, and this is the kind of style that that Galway Bay are really well known for and really, really well loved for. Kind of quite sort of old school traditional styles, but done absolutely perfectly. And I know they do, they do a bit of cask as well, and you can see why, because this is the kind of beer that would be really, really good, just sort of softly carbonated, well kept, and it's a point to savour, I would say. So next time you're in Ireland or Northern Ireland, check them out. Northern Lights in particular is a fantastic bar. They have a really good vegan chili there, and Siobhan, who runs the bar, is an absolute hoot. Get her telling you stories, and you'll be there all night. So cheers.
Yeah, we're going to go to the pub quiz answer video just now. I've been really enjoying this beer. I hope you guys at home have also been enjoying it. And Rich, thank you for doing the little beer tasting there.
Not at all.
Yeah, definitely want to check out, especially if you're in the kind of Salt Hill region of Galway. But let's go to the answer to the pub quiz question.
How many points did Liverpool accumulate before the postponement of the 2019-2020 season? The answer is 82.
Hope you're doing well in the pub quiz.
There you go.
We will be announcing winners as the night goes on. Remember, you can win a box of beer just for answering a pub quiz question. Can't say fairer than that. But, you know, I've got a nice beer in my hand, Rich. I feel like I need some entertainment. You know what I mean?
I'm not doing that again, Doug. We've talked. There are
that's
boundaries.
That's for after
we need
the stream,
boundaries.
Rich. That's for after the stream.
Okay.
No, we're going to do a quick bit of entertainment for you from the musician Wilds. You may recognize her from the video that kicked off the night, the socially distanced orchestra, the Hackney Colliery Band. But first, we're going to see Wilds.
Hi everyone, I'm Wild, and thank you for having me at Cyberfest, your online beer festival. It's such a pleasure to be here, and to celebrate, I think we should listen to a couple of songs. This next one is called Illuminate, and we recorded it up on the roof, and I hope you enjoy.
Tell me what I'm waiting for, I've waited so long. So long, and tell me what I've got to do to make right of my wrongs. I'm on fire, can you see me burning up? I am reckless for your love. I'm more than a shadow dancing free. I know that you see me more clearly, but it'll mean nothing without you. And I see I've been held back by the darkness in my mind. And I see that I'll never win the war against time. I'm on fire, can you see me burning up? I am reckless for your love. I'm more than a shadow dancing free. I know that you see me more clearly. It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing without you. It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing without you. Ooh. To me though, honey, if you can illuminate, illuminate, please illuminate, illuminate, please. 'Cause it'll mean nothing, it'll mean nothing without you. It'll mean nothing without you. It'll mean nothing. 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 It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing. It'll mean nothing without you. You've got a hold on me. got a hold on you. You can't let me go. I can't let go of you. It's in the air I breathe. It takes over me. I can't let you go. So say I'm the sun. Say I'm the rising light above. You'll be the waves. Then come crashing down, love. Say I'm the moon. Be the night that holds me up. You'll make it rain. And we'll wash away the floods. Trace of me, my doubt in you. So say I'm the sun, say I'm the rising light above. You'll be the waves, and come crashing down, love. Say I'm the moon, be the night that holds me up. You'll make it rain, and we'll wash away.
Thank you so much, Wilds. What I personally love about contributions like that is it really highlights how, like, wildly unprofessional the rest of this endeavour is.
Don't know what you mean, Rich.
When we have something that... No, present company accepted, Doug, obviously. Yeah. Obviously. Okay, so we have a quiz winner. Nicole Higgs correctly said that Liverpool had 82 points before the Premier League season was postponed. So well done, Nicole. Your beers are, if not on their way right now, then at least being processed. We have some shout-outs. There's been lots of you getting in touch asking for some love for your love. You're a bunch of romantics out there tonight. Last time it was all like hen parties and like, you know, 30th birthdays in Magaluf, but not in Magaluf because nobody was travelling. Christine Hindle wants a shout out to my husband of her husband of 30, not my husband, of 32 years. We have drunk so many beers together over the years, and may it be many more. Cheers, sweetheart. That was from Christine as well, not me.
It was lovely. We do have another shout out here from C. Wilcox. C. Wilcox would like to give a shout out to their friend Jamie Watson, who got... and this is from the shout out. Me and my wife hooked on Beer 52 and Cyberfest.
Oh, great.
Good job, Jamie.
Good shout out.
His friends call him Shamey because every time he has a few drinks, he shames himself. I would like video evidence of said Shamey.
As we were saying, send pics.
Yeah, send pics, send videos, do the thing.
Last shout out for now. Yisioko from the YouTube chat wants a shout out for... their wife Laura's 33rd birthday and her always positive attitude when working with COVID-19 patients. P.S. Mango Berliner is awesome. Yes, it is. And thank you, Laura, from all of us as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
Great job. What's up next, Doug?
Next, we have a brewer video.
We do.
From O Brother. And it is The Nightcrawler is the name of the beer, which sounds like a beer superhero if you're an X-Men fan, or a Jake Gyllenhaal movie.
I love that Jake Gyllenhaal film. It's actually
really
good.
On a scale of blue fairy teleporting demon to crazy Jake Gyllenhaal, which are you?
1 to 10.
1 to 10. But yeah, we're going to go to the video from O Brother and their The Nightcrawler.
The Nightcrawler.
How's it going, everybody?
Hi, guys. Welcome to Cyberfest.
They're already outside.
Makes sense.
Yeah,
makes
sense.
Okay, fair enough. Well, we hope you welcome us to Cyberfest. We're delighted to be here at Cyberfest. Delighted to be pouring the Nightcrawler Stout with you guys today. So just want to say thanks a mil for having us. I'm Barry, Chief Dosser here at O Brother Brewing. This is Brian.
How's it going, everybody?
What do you do, Brian?
Chief Dosser, Ella.
Chief Dosser, Ella. Brian's our international head of sales. And Rich?
I'm Rich. I am head brewer and head keg washer.
Chief Mischief Maker. Fair play. So for any of you guys who don't know about O Brother Brewing, we set up in 2014. So we're going just over 5 years now, 5.5 years, set up to brew like every other brewer, the beers that we love to homebrew. So we're actually living proof that homebrewing is a very dangerous hobby and you could actually end up jacking in your jobs and secure futures and end up with a brewery of your own. But hey, here we are. We brew primarily hoppy, you know, American style IPAs, pale ales. I love the hops here. They were the beers that kind of got us into brewing in the first place. So they were naturally the beers that we set up to brew. We've four core beers. Nightcrawler is one of them that we have year round. The other three are all pale. So we've got the Dreamcatcher, the Sinner IPA, and the Chancer is an American pale. But I suppose, what else? What should we tell the guys? Where are you going, Brian? Brian, thanks for rejoining us. Brian seems to have gone for a little toilet break already. What are we drinking here? This is a new... Well, we decided to start a little bit early and have a couple of beers before we kicked off with you guys. So what else do we do? Well, like a lot of breweries, we love the collaborations. We try and bring a bit of what we like in our own personal lives into the brewery, work with different people that we find interesting, like-minded individuals. What have we done? Some
chocolate imperial stout with some chocolatiers.
Chocolatiers in Wexford, Bean and Goose. Done a good few coffee collabs. We absolutely love coffee here, so paired up with a few local roasteries in Dublin and around Wicklow. It's been a great crack. And then obviously, you know, it's always the collabs with the other breweries as well, which are good fun. Something that we really, really got into and absolutely had an absolute blast with, I should say absolutely one more time because I love saying absolutely, but the absolutely, Brian, the Off The Wall series. Brian's not going to actually say anything in this video, he's just going to stand in the corner and
drink
his beer and slag me, which is basically what he does all the time anyway. So back at the end of 2018, I think it was, we paired up with some Irish artists and we started our series of Off The Wall. So basically the concept was we took artwork that was on a wall somewhere, we thought we were very clever with that. And we took it off the wall and put it onto the can. And we got some of these dotted around here. Right, some of these are empty. That's what happened. So we got some fantastic artwork here from artists such as like the DMC, Emic, got some here from Kevlar, and what's this one? Bringer of Light. So this is one we did with JMK. So we've had an absolute blast with that. Massively into art. Love the street art scene and some of the stuff that the Irish artists do is absolutely amazing. So we're absolutely chuffed. See, I said absolutely again. Absolutely chuffed to have the privilege to get these lovely labels done with art featuring artists from around the country. And it's something that we're looking forward to doing a whole lot more of. So we do basically one every month or every little bit, sometimes two a month, depends on what kind of mood Rich is in, really.
Feeling energetic or not.
If he's feeling energetic or not. It doesn't look very energetic, but sometimes he is. We kind of range from mostly IPAs, double IPAs, like the rest of them. But
yeah, some sours done, some pales, bailout,
yeah. Done some saisons, we've done a triple IPA,
yeah,
which was,
that was really nice.
So we'll continue to do them, and we'll continue to do our core range beers, which we have all year round, and they're the beers that we go back to and love all the time. We're brewing here in beautiful County Wicklow in Ireland, as you know, and we have a 10 barrel brew house, and it's
small.
Well, small but perfectly full.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely, thanks Brian.
On to the Nightcrawler.
So yeah, let's get on to the Nightcrawler, and we'll do the tasting. You get out there, Brian, and then you're absolutely useless at beer tastings anyway. Not enough space for you. On to the beer. So Nightcrawler, as you can see on the can there, it's a milk stout. I'm sure most of you are aware that Ireland is completely awash with a very famous generic traditional stout. Permeates every little corner of this island, everywhere you look, every pub you go into. So naturally we decided to do something quite a bit different, and we went in the opposite direction. So ours is a milk stout, it's a sweet stout in an American style, our take on the milk stout style. It's got lactose in it, and nice smoothness from the oats. I'm going to hand over to Rich here to do the actual tasting. Rich, why do you not have an umbrella glass?
Budget cuts.
Budget cuts? I think Brian's owned them all. Right, get into it there.
Yeah, so it's American style. Although, we use a few.
I got that one as well, Rich.
British malts, so it's on the base of Maris Otter. Roasted barley, chocolate, Munich. What else?
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
What are you getting, Rich? You're getting loads of lovely chocolate there on the nose.
Yeah, big roasty kind of hit initially, and then fading into chocolate.
I already said chocolate.
Bit of caramel. Sweetness from the lactose is nicely balanced by the hops. Using Centennial
in this, yeah. Get some vanilla there as well. The taste.
Yeah, nice drinkable. Still very rich and extravagant.
Extravagant 4.5% sessionable milk stout. Absolutely love this all times of the year. It's actually great even in the summertime. A lot of people tend to veer away from the darker beers in the summertime, but it's got a lovely refreshing element to it as well, so I actually love this year round.
Yeah,
even though we are a very hoppy, pale focused brewery, always love coming back to the Nightcrawler. Really chuffed to have it at Cyberfest, guys, as we said. Absolutely delighted. Hope you enjoy this beer. And maybe you might get your hands on some of the other beers. This is pretty much our, it's our only dark beer that we do year round as part of the core range, so you can get it at all times. But yeah, cheers.
Oh look, Ryan's coming back. Good man, Ryan.
Cheers, lads. As usual, didn't get a word in the 20s with you there.
No problem.
But yeah, and great to be involved. Thanks for having us. Beer 52, Cyberfest 3. Hope you really enjoy the beer. Hope you really enjoy all the other beers as well. Cheers.
Cheers, guys. Cheers. See you soon. Sláinte.
Sláinte.
Day crawler, fighter of the night crawler. Okay, moving swiftly on.
Always Sunny reference has to be done. That's all we could think about the entire time the Your Brother video was playing.
We have been singing that non-stop for the last 10 minutes, so you can imagine the fun we've been having.
So fun.
Some shout outs. Edward Bennett, for some reason written in capitals. Edward Bennett! Shout out to Mike Dad and Mum Mary, pushing 70, but still chugging beer with the young'uns. Jamie Whitten and Helen, this is their third Cyberfest and they are loving it.
Fantastic.
Amundsen was amazing. Yes, it was, wasn't it? That's fantastic. James Woods, a Cyberfest 1 veteran, his wife Iona, he has left her. Sorry, he has left her half of each of the beers so far. She just joined after finishing her shift. So, Iona, enjoy those dregs,
yeah,
won't you? Well done, James. It's very generous of you. next up, we've got a bit of a creative experiment for you. Doug has been working on this project himself. This is a Beer 52 pilot. Which we're definitely not calling Beerable Histories for legal reasons.
But yeah.
Doug, tell us a bit more about it.
Yeah, so during lockdown, we've obviously been doing these Cyberfests, and we've had so much fun doing these kind of live stream events and doing more kind of content for the YouTube channel that I've been tasked with coming up with ideas to put on for Beer 52 so that we have some more content to spread with you lovely folks at home, and maybe... I thought I'd take the opportunity to maybe be a bit educational with it. I'm a big fan of history. I studied that at university. So I thought, beer, history, beer, great idea. So what we're going to see is the pilot episode shot entirely on a phone camera. It's better than it sounds. And in my flat in Edinburgh for Beer Through the Ages. And we're going to be talking about the first beer. Roll the video.
Eat the food, Enkidu. It is the way one lives. Drink the beer, as is the custom of the land. Enkidu ate the food until he was sated. He drank the beer, 7 jugs, and became expansive and sang with joy. He was elated and his face glowed.
What a lad. If you were looking for a set date in the timeline of human history when beer was created, you would be disappointed. The truth is, we don't have an exact date, and it's doubtful that we ever will. Let's go through what we do know.
Part 1. A long time ago, not so far away.
Fermentation is a naturally occurring process. Essentially, if fruit, for example, is left to break down over time, the wild yeast in the air will feed on those tasty fruit sugars, creating alcohol. Yeast and sugar are both naturally occurring. They don't need us. And we know that animals predating humans, and indeed early humans, both discovered the effects of fermentation in semi-rotting fruit. Accidental fermentation, a tradition valiantly continued by students and teenage boys, one forgotten mug of tea at a time.
Oh boy, tea.
But, as Nan used to say, a rotten plum does not a beer make. By definition, a beer has to use a grain of some kind. The process is a little more involved. So, while it is clear that alcohol existed before humans, we need to look a little bit later before we start seeing humans deliberately creating fermented drinks. Archaeological evidence has been found showing fermented drinks in China as early as 9,000 years ago, made from honey, fruit, and rice, among other things. Evidence of even earlier beer-like beverages has been found among the Natufians at the Raqqafe cave site when what is now Israel, around 13,000 years ago. Yeah, really hard to pronounce those, so sorry. It is believed that these were more gruel-like and were used in ritual feasting. In fact, the argument has been made that beer, alongside bread, was one of the key ingredients to the building of civilizations. By which we mean settled communities and the rise of agriculture. As with the fermented fruits, domesticated cereals also contain sugars which fermented easily with the wild yeast in the air. Bread and beer made from these cereal grains led to an increase in nutrition and led to technological improvements that allowed humans to go from nomadic wanderers to sedentary societies, communities that stayed in one place. I can just picture the elders on the cusp of sedentary communities just looking like, look at you, with your walls and your barley and your emerging legal systems. In my day, you had to run down deer, poke it real hard with stick. What's that? Well, I guess I could stay for one drink. But all this is by way of a prologue. It appears that beer and beer-esque drinks were discovered at various locations at different points in history, independent of each other. This being said, the earliest concrete evidence we have of beer being actively and deliberately brewed comes from chemical tests of ancient pottery dating back 7,000 years ago to ancient Mesopotamia, what is now Iran. So, if we are looking for the beginning of the history of beer, ancient Mesopotamia, not a bad place to start.
Part 2. Ancient Beer.
But what did beer look like a few millennia ago? The ancient method of brewing was closely linked with baking. For example, bipa, a twice-baked barley bread, was used in the creation of some of the earliest brewed beers. Those of you who don't like a bit of yeast at the bottom of your any IPAs, I can hear you cringing from here. But does that mean that an ancient Mesopotamian pint looked like this? Probably not. But ancient beer did look a little bit different to what you'd get down the pub today.
Or at least what you could get before the lockdown. God, I miss sticky floors and ignoring football in a crowded room.
Beers brewed by the ancient Mesopotamians, ancient Egyptians, and Babylonians didn't use hops for a start. They were also drunk communally from earthenware jugs using straws, made from reeds or gold if you were a member of the ruling class and really wanted to rub it in. Down with these bourgeois capitalist straws, I drink with a reed like a common man. This isn't a reed, it's a bit of lemongrass, but it's the closest I had to a reed. Anyway. Fun fact, the drinking straw was actually invented specifically so people could drink beer and avoid all the bits of bread and herbs and what we'd call adjuncts or flavouring additives that were found at the bottoms of the jars. This isn't to say there aren't some similarities with modern brewing. The world's first large-scale brewery was built by the Egyptians. There were 20 recognized beer styles, ranging from darker to lighter beers, and they also had strict health regulations surrounding the production of beer as well. Although the punishment for breaking these regulations could be a lot more severe than it would be today. For example, there are stories of bad brewers being drowned in their own beer.
Okay. No more homebrew.
There was a reason the production of beer was so heavily monitored. Besides being big beer nerds, the ancient Egyptians, alongside their Mesopotamian neighbors, paid their workers in beer, and beer was an integral part of the diet of ancient peoples. Often, it was safer to drink than the regular water, and it was also surprisingly nutritious. If you are interested in seeing more about how the ancients brewed beer, check out the link in the description. It's from the British Museum, where they actually made some ancient Egyptian beer. And I've got to be honest, it looks surprisingly good. Really tasty. I really want to try it.
Part 3. The Hymn to Ninkasi.
But who was doing all the brewing? The image we have right now of brewers, a stereotype really, is white men with big beards who wear plaid and talk about beer and craft beer and... Why are you looking at me? I own a copy of this book. I can't get rid of it. It's part of my identity. This is a nightmare. Help! This image comes from the medieval and early modern period. But in reality, women have mostly, if not always, been the leaders in brewing. This is because the vast majority of beer was brewed in the home as part of meals. As we've said, the link between beer and bread baking was very strong. And because women were doing most of the baking, they also did most of the brewing. I'm onto you, Mary Berry. You can't hide the bake-off beer! The relationship between women and beer is perhaps best showcased in the form of the goddess Ninkasi and her devotees. Ninkasi was the Sumerian goddess of beer. In fact, the Hymn of Ninkasi, from around 3,900 years ago, is the earliest known example we have of a beer recipe.
Ninkasi, you are the one who waters the malt set on the ground. The noble dogs keep away even the potentates. Ninkasi, you are the one who soaks the malt in a jar. The waves rise, the waves fall. Ninkasi, you are the one who spreads the cooked mash on large reed mats. Coolness triumphs. Ninkasi, you are the one who holds with both hands the great sweet wort, brewing with honey wine. Ninkasi, when you pour out the filtered beer of the vat, it is like the flow of the Tigris and the Euphrates. Conclusions.
So there we have it. This was a very brief summary of the early history of beer. I hope you've enjoyed it. This was a bit of an experiment to see if this kind of thing would work. If you like this and you want to see more, please do let us know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe to Beer52's YouTube. And obviously, you know, you can tweet us at beer52.com. Or is it just at beer52? I don't know. Do the tweet. Yeah, this has been a lot of fun for me. I finally got to put my degrees to good use in history. Before this, the most historical thing I'd done was a comparison between Dante's Inferno and the movie Cats from 2019. So, yeah, I don't know. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoy your beer. and now you can be a beer nerd in front of your friends and, well, actually them into the ground of the bottom of their pint. Cheers.
Thank you, Rich. Thank you for watching, guys. I do hope that you enjoyed that. If you would like to see more content, I've got loads more ideas, like looking at medieval beers and how they were brewed, looking at IPAs and where they come from, all that kind of good stuff about beer history. So if you want to learn a bit more, let us know. Hashtag Cyberfest3, tweet us in, or you can email us at cyberfest@beer52.com. I just want to shout out a quick other product, though, from my co-host Rich. Because if you want to know more about the history of beer and more about beer in general, you can pick up a copy of the Craft Beer Dictionary in the world's most subtle plug by Richard Crosdale.
Stop it!
It's a fantastic book. It's filled with all this like fantastic information. The stuff that I was talking about the world's first beers, also in here. The book is available on Amazon and at all good bookshops. So if you find yourself in a bookshop in the next while, or you find yourself on Amazon, pick up a copy. It's fantastic. Just going to pop that down because we have some more shout-outs to give. So I'm going to butcher some pronunciations right now. I'm very sorry. Makbul in London, she is Turkish, and her husband Gabor is Hungarian. You've given us a word that's not in English here, so again, apologies. Egeskadre. I've really messed that up, and I'm so sorry. But Egeskadre to you both. Well done. Thank you so much for joining us for Cyberfest 3. Apologies again, but I hope you're having a wonderful evening. We also have a shout-out from John O'Connor. John O'Connor sent 4 emails to ask for shout-outs to the Whiskey Boys. Sam, Eric, Matt, Bill, Dave, John. Praise Matt's horse. Leave Matt's horse alone. We are from around the country. Also, Tank Top Boys and Hairdo. You know, sometimes these shout-outs do feel like we're giving code to some kind of secret cell or cabal that's about to take over the UK.
The invasion has just started, Doug. Well done.
I've just accidentally started World War III with that shout-out, but who knows? Maybe they'll be benevolent. I, for one, welcome our benevolent Praise Matt's Horse, Leave Matt's Horse Alone overlords. it's a fun old night, isn't it? Rich, what have we got coming up next?
Next, Doug, we have, is it Mobily?
I believe it is, yeah.
I believe it is. Great brewery. Relatively recent, and they just sort of sprung fully formed like a young deer. We've been really impressed by their beers from day one. They're kind of a regular in the Beer 52 box, and we have a superb beer from them tonight, and a superb video to accompany that beer.
And it's one that I will be drinking along with. So folks at home, if you want to drink along with your old pal Doug over here, I'm going to be joining you for this Mobily beer. So let's get stuck in.
My name's Rick, I'm from Mobily Brewhouse, and this evening we are going to be drinking Playback, Playback is our homage to the West Coast IPA, but with a little tweak to make it more sessionable and slightly less bitter than you'd normally experience with this beer. So, who are we? Where are we? We are in Cheshire. We are from Mobberley. Not Wobberley, not Moberley, but Mobberley. It's about 6 miles south of Manchester. From our brewery, we can see Manchester Airport's control tower. How exciting is that? Anyway, we've been brewing since 2011. We brew cask, can and keg. You can find our beers as high up as Inverness, as low down as Land's End. If you're a little further afield, you can find our beers in France, Spain, Belgium, and hopefully coming soon to Italy and other areas.
Hi, I'm Phil. I'm one of the co-owners of the Mobberley Brewhouse. We're really delighted to be involved in Cyberfest this year, and we hope you enjoy Playback as much as we do. Cheers.
Hi, my name's Chris. I've been with the brewery 5 years now. I started on an apprenticeship, and now I'm the production manager. My roles are basically just making sure that we've got beer, making sure there's beer in tank, making sure we've got the stuff to make beer, and just keeping everyone happy.
Okay, so now that you've met some of the team, let's get Playback cracked open. So, initially on opening, I'm getting quite a bit of grapefruit. I'm also getting toffee and caramel. Got a nice, clean, tight white head, good carbonation level. Cheers, Cyberfest. So initially, still getting that grapefruit. That's then giving way to a really nice malt base, some underlying toffee notes, and then as we're getting towards the mid, there's an increase in the residual bitterness, and that's now fading to give a slightly dry finish with just a tiny bit of sweetness. Hope you enjoy it. We certainly enjoyed being part of Cyberfest. Cheers!
Some more shout outs for you now, ladies and gents. Lisa Charles sending a big shout out to her boyfriend Steve, who is already a bit pissed.
That's what we like to hear.
Told you to pace yourself, Steve. I think you're in trouble, mate. Nick Johnson, a shout out for Rachel the Vampire Slayer.
What happened to Buffy?
What did you do to Buffy?
What did you do?
For embracing his love of proper beer. Bit snobby, Nick. Really? But, you know, fine. You've got some shout-outs as well, Doug?
I do indeed. We've got a shout-out. Paul Simpson and his wife, Maria, celebrating their 16th wedding anniversary with Cyberfest. Guys, I don't know what to say. That's so nice of you.
I'm so touched. It's lovely.
I hope it's a good wedding anniversary for you. I really do. Suzanne Kressel, shout-out to her husband, Keith, who just landed his dream job. Congratulations, Keith. Well done. And we have one more here, Philip Murphy and Pauline, who have done every Cyberfest so far and got every pub quiz question wrong so far tonight. Well done.
Amazing.
Drinks to you.
Good effort.
Of course, I am drinking the Mobberley beer, just in case you missed that before the video started. I don't know about you guys. I really want to hear your thoughts on it, but I'm really enjoying it. It's a really nice, easy drink. Mm. And I think it's going to go perfectly with the next segment that we got coming up. Because we've got a bit of entertainment. So if you're on a beer just now, you can kick back, relax, really enjoy all the things that beer is offering you. Because we have the wonderful, the amazing Hugh Kelly, a local Scottish artist, who's going to give you some really awesome gravelly voice and blues music. It's going to be amazing.
See you shortly.
See you shortly.
I just don't feel right, she said about a month ago. So I live with thoughts in my head and feeling so alone. You don't have to try to smile, we can stop and leave for a while. There's nothing you have to show, you don't. It might just look like that's how you're feeling through somebody else's eyes. In need of comfort, looking for healing. Got the ones who left outside. We can sleep where the light won't find us. Close our eyes, leave the world behind us. Building bridges, and although it doesn't mean much, turning miles into inches so that nothing comes between us. So much to say, but never say anything. Just tell me what you're feeling. We can do anything, anything. I'll give you what you're needing. It might just look like that's how you're feeling through somebody else's eyes. In need of comfort, looking for healing. Got the ones who lived outside. We can sleep where the light won't find us. Close our eyes, leave the world behind us. I just look like that's how you're feeling through somebody else's eyes. In need of comfort, looking for healing. Got the ones who left outside. We can sleep where the light won't find us. We can sleep where the light won't find us. We can sleep where the light won't find us. Close our eyes, leave the world behind us.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Hugh Kelly. Big thank you to Beer 52 for having me. This is exciting. Yeah, I'm going to play a few tunes for you. This next song, I'm going to jump on the piano. This is called Any Other Way. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much.
Wake me up when it's over. Every morning's the same. Till the curtains part and the light consumes my face. Tell me something with meaning. tell me what's in your head. As we're creeping around like spiders making webs. Cause we don't need much if we hope for the best. We keep each other warm, spend the day in bed. So don't break me, you make me. I'm never gonna let you go. We've said everything we need to say, and it's just you and me today. Wouldn't have it any other way. You got me overexcited. Let's go live where the light is. Cause nothing's ever felt so real to me. So don't break me, you make me. I'm never gonna let you go. We said everything we need to say. This is you and me today. Your love is my cover. Keeps me sheltered like no other way. We said everything we need to say. And it's just you and me today. Cause we don't need much. We hope for the best. Keep each other warm. Spend the day in bed. We don't need much. Got coffee and sex. Keep each other warm. Spend the day in bed. So don't break me, you make me. I'm never gonna let you go. We've said everything we need to say. And it's just you and me today. Your love is my cover. Keeps me sheltered like no other way. We said everything we need to say. And it's just you and me today. Wouldn't have it any other way.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, to say thank you to Beer 52 for having me. Yeah, my name is Hugh Kelly, and if you like what you heard so far, there's at Hugh Kelly Music more or less everywhere, and hughkellymusic.com. So yeah, feel free to follow. This next song is called Words Unspoken. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Struck down by a lightning bolt in the doorway of your room. Misty-eyed, unsatisfied, knowing what's coming soon. Feeling breathless though I do all the time. I feel the weight as it dances down my spine. And I wonder if we ever really tried. I felt the pain before you drew the knife. Tears falling as the clouds are open. I prayed for the rain with the words unspoken. If we ever cross paths again, love, I know that once would be enough.
fast then I fade to gray, like a thunderclap in the pouring rain. I made a plea to God to come and whisk me away. I've got to realize things will never be the same. Tears falling as the clouds are open. I prayed for the rain with the words unspoken. If we ever cross paths again, love, I know that once would be enough. Clouds are open. I pray for the rain with the words unspoken. If we ever cross paths again, love, I know that once would be enough. Thank you very much. I've got one last song. Thank you all for listening, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your virtual festival. It's amazing that these things can happen when we're all apart, but I'm glad they're happening. Thank you very much. This song's called Morphine Dreams. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
On his upper lip and barbed wire around his head, his cocaine eyes filled with a revelation as he's trying hard to forget. Now all it is shock, shock, shock till his mind is undone and he's lying on the floor. And he's feeling sick, sick, sick with the lies that he's told and the person he become. So leave it all behind, leave it all behind. So leave it all behind. Oh, yeah, ooh. Oh. His supple wrists won't get involved as the fun starts to descend, because the morphine dreams just ain't your scene. You're scared that you'll be next. So leave it all behind, leave it all behind. So leave it all behind. Yeah, leave it all behind. Ooh, no. Because the morphine dreams just ain't your scene. Yeah, the morphine dreams just ain't your scene. Yeah, the morphine dreams just ain't your scene. So leave it all behind. Yeah, the morphine dreams just ain't your scene.
Thank you.
Holy moly, Hugh Kelly. We are all absolutely blown away by that. And judging from the comments, you guys all are as well. So thank you thank you so much, Hugh, for that amazing set. You can find more of his music at hughkellymusic.co.uk. Do please check it out. An incredible, incredible local talent. We're really lucky to have him on Cyberfest. Some more shout outs. Matthew Meaney, shout out to the Geordie Boys. Darren, James, Greg, Steve, and Matt, who are all hanging out in Cyber Alley just now. Now, for those of you new to Cyberfest, Cyber Alley is our online street of bars, basically, where you can just pop in, meet other Cyberfest goers, have a chat. It's kind of like a sort of random Zoom video thing. It's absolutely brilliant fun. The only thing I would say is if you go just now while the live feed is running, please put headphones on, because otherwise you get crazy echoes and feedback, and it's no good for anyone. Lucy Couchman, shout out to her parents, Jude and Paul, on their 49th wedding anniversary. Good effort.
Cheers to you guys.
That's, oh, and even better. God, I mean, 49 years. Okay, great, you know, fine. Dad is making her a 50th anniversary double dry hopped Nipah. He's got 1 year to get it right.
Amazing.
I mean, basically, all I want in a relationship and in my life is for somebody to make me a double dry hopped Nipah for our 50th wedding anniversary. I mean, that's couples goals. Hashtag.
Absolutely.
Right there. Doug, you've got some shout outs as well?
I don't at the moment, Rich.
Oh,
but
I thought you did.
Again, if you do want to get some shout outs, email cyberfest@beer52.com, or, you know, put them in the YouTube comments, or tweet us at Beer52HQ using the hashtag Cyberfest3. We've got people looking at everything at the moment, so please do send us some good vibes, whoever you want to shout out. You know, if you want to signal to another group that you're watching, please do let us know, and we'll try and do that for you.
Or if you just want to say hi to our amazing colleague Frieda, who is just intercepting all of these things as they come in and scribbling them down and making sense of them for us. She's doing an amazing job, so thank you very much, Frieda.
Absolutely.
Up next, we have... this is an absolutely sensational beer. I'm going to be drinking this one. It's honestly, it sounds horrible, but it's like drinking a crunchy. I like crunchies. I like beer. It's... Whoa!
You okay, Rich?
I'm sorry. Yeah, that wasn't classy at all. It just got a little bit lively, and I basically swallowed half the can. It was actually a little bit obscene.
The beer gods are telling you to drink from a glass now, Rich. That's all
yes,
I'm saying.
Right. Oh, God.
But no, it is Seven Brothers we got coming up next.
You're my beer etiquette dad. it's an absolutely great beer, and it's so sweet, and it does taste like a crunchy. This is their honeycomb. So let's, I'm spraffing on about it. Let's watch the video. Hey everyone, it's Keith here from Seven Brothers. We're here today to try a couple of beers. One in particular is our Honeycomb Pale Ale. Hope you guys are having a great time in the Beer 52 Cyberfest. So in a minute, we'll crack this one open and we'll tell you all about it. Cheers. One of the first questions we do get asked is, are we actually Seven Brothers? And the answer is yes. So the name was pretty easy to come by. We established back in 2014, so we've been trading about 6 years now. And we've just gone from strength to strength. From a very small brewing kit with only 5,000 litres of fermenting capacity to the brewery that you see now, which is 60,000 litres of fermenting capacity and a much, much more sophisticated setup. So, how did we get into craft beer? Well, we actually grew up making homebrew with our dad, and we all kind of got into it in different stages in our lives. And that's where it all started for us. Some of us got into it a little bit more than others. So our brother Kit, for instance, he was our first head brewer. He was also a science teacher before he got into this full time.
And he was the one who went out and got some quals and learned how to start making beer. So we've obviously gone on from strength to strength. We're actually, from a family point of view, we're all self-taught. We've made all the mistakes under the sun in terms of making quality, consistent craft beer. We do have an amazing team behind us now from the brewing team. We have Greg. He's one of the brothers and he's our lead technical brewer. We have Jack, who joined our team a few years ago now, and he's our creative head brewer. Then we have Eddie. Eddie's one of our assistant brewers and always got something to say about which direction we should go in, which is perfect. And then we have Dan, who's another one of our assistant brewers. And then we have Harry. Harry's one of our newest additions to the team, and he's already showing some great promise, but he's getting stuck into the nitty-gritty of the brewing side of things. So as well as our brewery here, we have our own bars as well, which we've been opening since 2016. We call them our Seven Brothers Beer Houses. We have our first one in Ancoats in Manchester, our second one just on the outskirts of Manchester, and we've got our third and fourth opening in Liverpool and Leeds in the next 6 months. So we're really, really excited about that, and we hopefully, it's more places for you guys to come and try our craft beer. Also, where I'm sat at the moment is our brand new brewery tap. We've basically taken everything up, so you can see all the brewery floor down there. We've now got this amazing space up here, and we've got the brewery that we've built ourselves over there. And yeah, strange times, and we've only just been open the last few weeks. But as lockdown eases and people's confidence comes back, we're hopefully going to be having loads and loads and loads of people come here over the next months ahead. Alright guys, so we're here today to taste our Honeycomb Pale. You should have this beer in your Beer 52 Cyberfest box. So we're just going to have a little bit of a taster, and I'll give you some notes I've got written down here about the beer actually, and I'll just tell you all about it. So here we go guys, we're going to crack this one open. So in this particular beer, we've got a variety of malts. We have our best ale malt. We've got a caramel malt. We have caramel malt for a little bit of sweetness and color. And we have crystal malt as well. And there's only a small amount of crystal malt that we use. So as you can see, it's a beautiful color. Absolutely great color. So I suggest you guys give it a bit of a sniff. First thing I get is lots of rich caramel honeycomb aroma. Instantly, I can taste that it's a honey-based beer. So, you guys, tell me what you think, and we'll have a swig. Let's give it a try. What a lot of people have been feeding back to us on this particular beer is that it's like tasting crunchy in a can, and it's proven really, really popular over the last 6 months that this beer has been available. It really, it does pack a punch, and it's all so vegan. So you guys who are all vegans, get yourself down to the web shop to get some more of this, and hope you enjoy it. Cheers.
Awesome stuff. Thank you again to Seven Brothers, and also thank you guys for your sponsorship of the very attractive glasses for this Cyberfest 3. Went out with every box. I think they're the smartest glasses yet, so thank you so much for that. A few more shout outs. Matt Walker sending a shout out to Sonia watching from Canada. She's jealous she doesn't have the box, but making up for it with local Canadian beers. Speaking of Canada, I would like to give a personal shout out to my good friend Summer, who is a former Beer 52 colleague, but is sadly having to go back home in a few days' time because her visa's run out. Summer, you will be very greatly missed, not just by me, but hopefully you'll make it back someday soon. Nick Bennett, shout out to you guys for doing such a stellar job.
Us?
Little me. He's having an awesome time, even though he's on his own.
Aww.
Oh.
Well, you're not on your own technically. I mean, you've got 700 friends watching along with you, and you exactly. have me and Rich and everyone here who's helping us film this.
Also, Andrew Groom and Finley Bain have got shoes on head in respect for young Hagrid's plant, which is a joke you will only get if you are deeply immersed in the YouTube comments for all three Cyberfests so far. So,
Cyberfest lore.
Cyberfest lore. That is canon now. Doug, you've got some bits and bobs.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that, of course, if you are enjoying the beers from your Cyberfest box, head on over to the shop if you want to get some more. That's beer52.com/shop. We do have a special code running at the moment, Cyber10. All the information is in the description, so you don't have to remember it. It's down there in the description for this video. Head on over, order some more beers. I was a big fan of the Honeycomb Pale, so I'll probably be ordering some more of that. And again, I'm still drinking the Mobley, and it's really nice, so I might get some more of that as well. And of course, you get 10% off with the discount code Cyber10. Everyone say it with me.
Cyber10. You'd be a fool not to.
Absolutely. But actually, we do have, speaking of Honeycomb Pale, we do have a little bit of an extra surprise for you guys. I managed to get together with Keith, who you might remember from the video, for Seven Brothers, one of the aforementioned Seven Brothers. And we had a brief chat about his beer and his brewery and what's going on there. So we're going to head over to that video now for a Skype, Zoom Q&A between myself and Keith from Seven Brothers.
Hi Keith, how's it going?
Not too bad, Doug. Yeah, how are you? All good?
Not too bad at all. Yeah. I suppose we should start the call by saying, thanks for taking part in Cyberfest and thanks for the video that everyone's just watched.
Yeah, it's our pleasure. I hope everyone enjoyed the video and the beers that went along with it as well. Yeah. So it's great to be involved, yeah.
Yeah, and an extra thanks for the glass as well, because you guys are the cool glass sponsors.
Yes, we did, yeah. So hopefully people will be using those for many weeks to come, and our name will be on those. That's all good.
Yeah, I've already started using mine. For the sake of the illusion, we are recording this prior to Cyberfest, and I've already cracked a few beers into mine. It holds beer good, so well done on that count.
Yeah, cheers, man. Thanks.
But yeah, let's get stuck into this, because it's an interesting beer that you've given us, the Honeycomb Pale. I tried it just before the call, and it was phenomenal. But
great.
What kind of inspired it? Who came up with the idea of doing a Honeycomb Pale?
Well, the Honeycomb, we whenever we make a beer, it's always a beer that we've had before and that we fancy trying to replicate or maybe putting our own twist on things.
Yeah.
And this was no different. But what we found is that and I'm pretty sure all you brewers out there will understand that brewing with honey is notoriously difficult. It's really, really difficult to kind of get that honey kind of thing running throughout the theme of the whole of the beer.
Yeah.
And the inspiration, literally was just because we love making stuff that we've tried and making our own twist on things, basically. Yeah.
Yeah, it's fantastic. So were you using like actual like honeycomb and stuff in the beer, or was it?
Well, we do put some honeycomb in there. However, we do kind of add to it with some syrups as well.
Yeah.
And because what we find is that when you like I said before, it's really difficult when you brew with honey. It can a lot of those sugars can kind of ferment away, and you lose that essence of what you're trying to get. So we put in as much in as we can, and then use back it up with some syrups in there. But it's not just about that; it's about the balance. Good strong malt backbone, and getting the beer as balanced as possible. Totally. We did do a, I think you've got the 4% version actually, but we did a Honeycomb Max. And we upped the ABV up to about 6%, and it was outstanding again. So the brewers, our guys, are just amazing at what they do. So hats off to them. They nailed it again. But it seems to work well. We've got the balance of the beer pretty good, and we can mess about with the ABV if we like. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, speaking about you guys and the brewers and everything, you mentioned in the video that you got your start doing homebrew with your dad.
Yeah.
As a set of actual brothers, like seven brothers isn't just a name. It's not a reality.
Just a name. No, it is. It's one of the most common questions we do get asked.
Yeah.
We are seven brothers, and we started making homebrew with dad as we grew up, and we got into it at different ages, obviously. A few of us, you know, got more into drinking it than actually making it as we got older. But quite a few of us carried it on, and it made sense that one of our brothers, Kit, he was more into it than anybody, and so he was our first head brewer.
Yeah.
He's moved on now within the company. He's into export sales now. It was a childhood love and passion that we all had, but never for one minute did we ever think that we would ever be able to start a business as a brewery. Absolutely no idea whatsoever, that we could do that. So we just all went off on our own careers, engineering, etc. But what it's proved is that we're all, there's so many skills that we can bring to the table in running a commercial brewery, because there's a lot more to it than just brewing the actual beer. We pretty much built, the cooling system out there single-handedly. We can take care of it remotely. So we've got a lot of skills to bring to the table to stand us in good stead, because at the end of the day, it really is just a process plant. It's just beer in the pipes than, say, something else like oil. We all loved making beer growing up, and I've not homebrewed for a while, I have to say. I've lost a little bit of touch on that. We all loved it. Still do.
Fantastic. Have you got any advice for homebrewers at all? I mean, obviously, you're taking a break from it yourself to do big brewing.
The big brewing, yeah. Well, yeah. All I take care of nowadays are the commercial aspects of the business. But it's practice. Try and invest in some, kind of graduate to much more sophisticated equipment if you can, because it's all about control. Once you've got that control over the whole process, you will start to make some exceptional beers. But don't give up, really. But make sure you find a decent spot to do it in the house. Definitely don't do it in the kitchen. Yeah. Definitely don't do it in the kitchen unless you live alone. That is.
I think that's good advice for anyone with a partner or anything. What's this bucket? We'll just take that to the side. I guess the whole reason like Cyberfest exists is because of COVID-19 and the lockdown and everything.
Yeah.
And fortunately we are kind of starting to come out of that a bit, but we're doing a Q&A with a brewer. I feel like I would be remiss if I didn't ask kind of what that was like for you as a brewery. And obviously if there's any advice you would give to us as kind of consumers of beer, like how best can we support you guys?
First of all, I think with any business throughout the whole of the country, that those initial weeks were probably the scariest. It was complete uncertainty, complete unknown. But we set our stall out pretty quick. We got to grips with where we were financially. We knew what we needed to do in order to kind of survive. Those first few months, we just set about cracking on with things. But then what started to happen is as people realized that, they actually weren't going to get to the boozer anymore. They had to get their beer fixed somehow. And, we effectively turned into a 100% retail / e-commerce business, from being only about 20%, 30% of our business, literally overnight. We ended up brewing more than beer than ever. From a manufacturing point of view, we've come out of it in really, really good shape. From a bar operator's point of view as well, because we have two bars that we currently operate in Manchester. It was a little bit more uncertain, but we literally just mothballed those and we came out of it pretty well. So, in as far as we're concerned, you amazing beer guys out there and girls, you've already supported us to the hilt. You just kept on buying our beer, which was absolutely incredible. You guys single-handedly kept breweries like us open. So hats off to every single person out there.
everyone at Cyberfest gets to pat themselves on the back.
Absolutely. You know, it literally turned from, you know, 20-30% of our business to 100% overnight. And so from quickly having, so after putting some of the guys, you know, to 4 days a week, they're like, no, nope, you got to come back.
We need you
get
back.
Get brewing. Yeah. So we've come out of it pretty well.
Well, that's really good to hear. That's really fantastic. And I guess on a more hopeful note, we've got time for one more question, and it would be, you know, what's next for Seven Brothers? Have you got any exciting plans? Any new beers that you can maybe clue us in on? If it's not giving away too much.
Yeah. Well, you know, what's next? First of all, we didn't see the crisis as a reason to kind of bury our heads in the sand. We had lots of plans for 2020 anyway. The plans have gone to the right a little bit, but we're cracking on. We're going to be opening up two more beer houses. The first one will open up in Liverpool at the end of the year. And the fourth one will open up in Leeds about spring next year. We have a collaboration bar as well, which should have opened this year, which is an airport partnership bar. So we're the sole craft beer, well, it's the sole beer provider in a new bar in Manchester's T2. So that'll be getting back on track early next year. As for beers, we're constantly, you know, churning out our core beers. Mm-hmm. But we've got the infrastructure now in place to enable us to put out quite a few more specials throughout the year. We've just put out a passion fruit pale, which went down a storm. We're about to brew, actually, our next one. Shall I say, it's... If it's possible to do an Imperial Shandy, then we're going to do it. By all means, we're just going to putting the recipe together now, but that could be about 6 weeks, 7 weeks away.
There's going to be a bunch of beer lovers now just casually looking at Seven Brothers website every now and again just to be like,
is that possible? Yeah.
That sounds a ridiculous idea, and I would love to see what comes of that.
it's the brainchild of our head brewer, Mr. Jack Dixon, and he's really excited to get that off the ground. So we're just giving him free rein; he can do what he wants on that one.
Well, that sounds awesome. I look forward to seeing what comes out of Seven Brothers in the next few months. And obviously, for those people at home who are in the kind of Leeds, Liverpool, Manchester area, go check out the bars because they sound like they're going to be really good.
Go check it out. There's plenty of outdoor seating. We'll have all the COVID processes in place. It'd be great to see you all there. Yeah, it'd be great.
Fantastic. Well, thank you very much for taking this call and for doing the Q&A. And thanks for being part of Cyberfest.
My pleasure. Yeah, take care.
All right, have a good one.
Yeah, you too. See you later.
And thank you very much for that brewery video. I hope you guys are enjoying all the beers that are on offer. Remember, the Twitter poll is still running. Vote for your favorite beer. There's so many to choose from. I don't know how you guys are going to do it, but we are going to pick a winner, so get voting. I have some more shout-outs to give here. We've got one from Mal from Crew wants to shout out to Paul, who is looking after their daughter after her op. Good luck to her hubby on the first day of his new job. It's fantastic. Mark Cadell is a virgin to Cyberfest. Mark, welcome. You're in good company.
We'll be gentle.
Yeah, we will be gentle. We're gentle Cyberfesters. Great beer and no PPE because you're all social distancing. Huzzah. Cheers, Spike the Man, down in Dorset. Caps his name, so sorry. Cheers, Spike the Man! Down in Dorset. Next up, we have Neil, Matt, and Helen. Third-time veterans, loving the format and Cyberfest. Started the night with Bavarian pretzels.
Nice!
You're having a better night than we are. Can we join?
With mustard. We need to know details.
They're also looking forward to tomorrow's Cyberfest. So you guys are in it for the long haul. Oh.
Good effort.
We're going to have some good stuff for you tomorrow as well. Those of you joining up again tomorrow, we look forward to seeing you then. Now we have Alicia Smith. Shout out to Brian Lawton from York. Enjoying beers after long drive home from holiday. Fantastic. So welcome back. I hope you enjoyed your holiday. This is a good way to get, you know, ease into that weekend. No, we have a bit of a sad one here, guys, so we're going to need some rousing, sympathetic Cyberfest comments. David B. wants to shout out to... what's the name? Sorry, I can't read the spelling.
Danilo.
So David B. wants to shout out to Danilo, who is taking part in Cyberfest. Sadly, he had to put down his cat, Fudge, last night, so a little shout out would be great and cheer him up. So Danilo, you know,
that's tough.
Hearts go out to you, man. Yeah. I hope you're enjoying the beers at least. And yeah, everyone in the comments, let's show them what Cyberfest is all about. It's about good vibes and beer. So let's cheer up Danilo with some good beers and some good comments and some good wholesome chat. Rich, what have we got next?
Next up, we have another pub quiz question. You'll be pleased to hear another chance for you to win a case of beer. If you get the answer, please email it to cyberfest@beer52.com. Not on the YouTube chat. Then following that, we have an interview with our next brewery of the evening, Vocation. So let's take a look.
Hi everyone, it's Strictly Professional Katya Jones, and I have a question for you. Listen carefully. Where does bossa nova music come from?
Hi, my name's John Eckling. I'm the founder of Vocation Brewery. Welcome to the Beer 52 Cyberfest. So I'm going to show you around the brewery really quickly, and after that we're going to get down to tasting some beer. This is the old brew kit. It brews 2,500 litres a batch, so it's way too small for us now. This is the new brew kit. It brews 5,000 litres a batch, and we run it 24 hours a day. This is the cask washer. It's quite noisy. This is the laboratory. This is the centrifuge. And if you're going to shoot the carbonates in here, it's also very noisy. This is our barrel aging program. We've got lots of big strong stouts. Our outside tanks, we're 300 metres up in the Pennines, so it's always windy. And this is our new canning line, it does 15,000 cans an hour. Come down to our bar in Hebden Bridge to get a bit of peace and quiet, and so we're going to have a go at these beer tastings. By the way, if you ever are in Hebden Bridge, please do come and see us. It's a great little bar, 20 keg lines on, some really great Mexican inspired food, so really nice to see you if you're ever here. Okay, we're going to taste Double Attitude, which is our collab double IPA that we did with Salt Brewery. Salt is over in Saltaire. If you're ever over that way, they've got a great brew house with brilliant to visit. You can go there, they do with five pizzas. It's a brilliant spot, so do pop along. But Double Attitude, okay, it's a double West Coast IPA. In case you don't know, there is a difference between an East Coast IPA and a West Coast IPA. In a nutshell, we're talking about the American coasts here. West Coast IPAs tend to be clearer, a little bit more bitter, a little bit more of a kind of sort of, it's almost like a crunchy texture to them, even though that sounds nonsense for beer, but I think you know what I mean. East Coast IPAs tend to be juicier, maybe a bit sweeter, maybe hazier. So that's the difference. So in this beer, we're expecting a bit of clarity, a nice, crisp, bitter backbone to it. The hops in it are Centennial, Amarillo, Simcoe, and Columbus. So again, classic American hops, big, bold, punchy flavour. So let's pour some out and see how it looks. So it smells great already, I'm not just saying that. So you can see it's reasonably clear, we've not gone for a complete clarity, but it's, again, we're not going for that kind of juicy, murky East Coast vibe. This is a slightly clearer, crisper West Coast vibe. On the nose, it's lovely. It's a real kind of sherbety, orangey, little bit of grapefruit, kind of that sort of pithy character. And then to taste, it's pretty sweet as you'd expect for an 8% beer, but not overly so. Balanced out by that typical West Coast bitterness. a real long, lingering bitter finish that kind of makes you want a bit more. Well, I'm going to be careful because it's just about midday and I'm drinking 8% beer, so I'll take it steady. So yeah, lovely. It's not an overly malty character. It's that sherbety, lemony, orangey character. I guess that comes from the Amarillo. Amarillo hops and Simcoe are known for an orangey character. Yeah, really nice beer. But let me know what you think. That's my opinion. Taste it, get in touch, let us know what you think, and enjoy it. Cheers. Thanks for joining us on our brewery tour and tasting. Hope you enjoyed it. As I said on the tasting, that's my opinion. Love to know what you think of it, so get in touch, tell us what you think, and I hope you enjoy the beers. Thank you.
Where does bossa nova music come from?
Fantastic stuff from Vocation there. Lovely. And I do hope that you're doing well in the pub quiz. There's only, I think, one more question after this, maybe two. So, you know, if you want to win a box of beer, get your answers in now. Do it. Do the thing. Next up, we do have an amazing, amazing talent. Rich,
yeah.
How much do you remember of Cyberfest 2?
I was apparently there.
You were indeed.
I do remember one comic particularly stood out for me though, and for a lot of other people as well. And we're very lucky to have him back with some completely original material that he's recorded just for us.
Absolutely.
It's Toussaint Douglas.
Let's play the video.
He was a really popular act the last time round. So you're in for a treat.
Absolutely. Let's roll it.
I have a fear of dying on the toilet and everyone finding out how much loo roll I use.
I love the August bank holiday. Nothing beats the stress and many don't particularly know or like congregating around you to offer their opinions on your barbecuing. All comes close to the crushing disappointment of waiting over an hour for a sausage burnt to a crisp on the outside but inexplicably still raw in the middle as the rain your host assured everyone would be over in a few minutes quietly rolls down the side of your face. Today's episode of the Tucson Doug Show is brought to you by the good folks of Beer 52 and Cyberfest 3, the world's best online beer festival. Enjoy those craft beers responsibly. But you're at home, so who's gonna know, apart from the Russians? I'm just saying the Russians probably know. With lockdown easing and restaurants reopening, here at Morley's, we're committed to providing the same chicken shop experience you drunkenly enjoy after a night out and immediately regret the next day. We promise to use incredibly cheap, poor quality chicken wherever possible. To help us stop the spread of COVID-19, pay with contactless.
£5 minimum, card machine usually broken, not available in most chicken shops.
And lastly, we want to reassure our customers that all our spicy wings will be reheated for at least 7 days, so you know they're corona-free.
Morley's. Wait, is that a hair?
Hello everyone, welcome to Yoga for Nope, Not Today, Sorry with Jaheim Wicks. I'm Jaheim Wicks, this is Scuffles. Today we're going to be using a mat. If you don't have a mat, don't worry. Staying in bed till 12 works just as well. Hop into something comfy and let's get started. Okay, we're going to begin today's session curled up in a ball. Take your time coming down to the ground. And when we're on the ground, what we're going to do is use our pillow as a pillow. Notice where your thoughts go. You might be thinking to yourself that all lives matter, and that's okay. Lean into that. Use this time to allow any feelings you have. I like to let out the screams of 1,000 tormented souls doomed to spend an eternal damnation toiling away in the depths of hell. And when you're done, nice and slow, move back into an upright position. And we're going to end today's session with some breathing exercises. So inhale, you're anxious about the future. And exhale,
Your life is spiraling out of control. And inhale, you don't want to die alone. And exhale, you're a piece of shit. And as we bring our palms together, I want to thank you all for sharing your time and energy with me today. Although it's not like you had anything better to do. See you next time.
It's great that we finally get to go on an actual date.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, you don't have to wear a mask inside because everyone's had their temperature checked.
Okay, I guess I'll take off the mask then. Is that a continuous cough there?
No, silly, just a bit of food went down the wrong way.
Completing a football sticker album must be a nightmare if you're racist.
You always hear football pundits say, racism isn't just a football problem, it's a problem in our society.
Which means somewhere out there is a racist football fan stuck at home, determined to still be racist, watching the football on telly as he quietly makes monkey noises to himself. Until at some point, he looks down at the banana in his hand and is confronted with the question, if I make monkey noises but there are no black players around to hear it, am I still a racist or am I now a monkey?
Herrera hit by Hammers!
Track made history as the first show to have an all-black crew at the helm of the most famous ship in all of science fiction. Who can forget the iconic first words uttered by Captain Picard in the very first episode?
This is Captain John Barak Picard of the USS Roots, the first and only all-black Federation ship. There are currently three of us on board. Three!
You mean to tell me out of all of Starfleet you can only find three of us?
Starfleet have since acknowledged they have a diversity problem, particularly in senior positions, and have committed to strengthening their recruitment and development of black and minority ethnic talent.
And throughout its run, the show introduced an array of memorable characters that had never before been seen on our screens, like Chief Black Professional Officer Khalil Jabbar.
My credentials are impeccable. I have an MBA from Harvard and two law degrees from Stanford, yet I'm still consistently passed over for promotion in favor of my white peers. It is most illogical.
It's because of your name, Khalil. It's because of your name.
I swear by turmeric. It's amazing. I put in everything. My hay fever's acting up.
But we're indoors?
My therapist says I should see lockdown as an opportunity to make positive changes in my life, so I've cut out dairy.
Cool.
Wow, the food's really spicy.
The lemon and herb?
Where are you going? To self-isolate.
Absolutely brilliant. Absolutely loved that. That's fantastic. Thank you. Thank you so much, Tucson. That was just awesome. We have a quiz winner. We have another quiz winner. Chris Greenway and Rachel. The answer, bossa nova music, comes, of course, from Brazil. So previous Cyberfest attendees will already be aware that we produce a t-shirt for each of these, the proceeds of which go to charity. This Cyberfest is no exception, of course. So if you follow the link in the comments on the video, then you can buy yourself your very own piece of Cyberfest memorabilia. It's going to be a piece of beer history. I don't feel like I'm overhyping the importance of this t-shirt when I say that you will want to pass it on to your grandchildren and tell them that you were here. And of course, all of the proceeds, as previous festivals, go to charity. Doug?
Yes. Sorry, I just love the idea of a Cyberfest 3 t-shirt somehow ending up in a museum and people being very confused by it. This t-shirt commemorates some form of ancient festival. We believe it was used in ritual practice.
It was apparently the world's third first beer festival online.
Yes, the third first. But yeah, we've absolutely loved doing these Cyberfest festivals and sending you guys some really cool beers to drink along and have some fun with us while we're all sort of stuck in our houses and everything. As we move out of lockdown, we do want to keep doing stuff like this. So please do let us know, like tweet us with the hashtag Cyberfest3, say in the YouTube comments, email us at cyberfest@beer52.com. Let us know what you want to see next from Beer 52 and our like kind of video production. Do you want to see more stuff like the crazy French new wave film that we made with Phil, the black and white film that we had earlier? Or do you want to see more stuff like this where we do like an online festival? Do you want us to see us go to other festivals and kind of live stream from there? Let us know. And even if you want to let us know kind of where we should go with the boxes, what's an area of beer that you want to see Beer 52 tackle? Let us know and we'll have a look at it. We love to hear from you guys and we love to hear where you want us to go next. So, you know, as I say, leave your comments in the YouTube section on the side of the video somewhere. I'm just going to wave to both sides just in case. And tweet us at Cyberfest. Tweet us at Beer52HQ with the hashtag Cyberfest3. Rich, what we got coming up next?
Next up, we have another fantastic brewery, Van der Beek. I had this beer sat on a jetty on Loch Lochy last night, trying to catch trout with some worms that I just dug up out of the ground, and it was pretty much a perfect moment for me. The beer, the lack of fish, the lake, the rain, the midges. It was a strange kind of paradise, Doug, but it's the kind of paradise that I want to spend eternity in.
Well, I want to take a part of that, so we're going to drink along with this beer. It's Van der Streek.
Cyberfest, good morning. This is Jorik, the Van der Streek beer from the Netherlands. Not in Amsterdam, we're from Utrecht. We just drink beer here, not smoked pot. We're here to drink and taste the Sabo Session IPA. Cheers, Sabro Session IPA, 4.8%, full of Sabro hops, which is an American hop variety from Yakima Chief, our hop supplier in the States, full of coconut, tropical fruit. Delicious. We like American hops a lot. You know, we love America. We visited last year. Visited Trillium, Treehouse, Hill Farmstead, Otter Hall, Foam Brewing, Alchemist, you name it, we've been there. Let me show you the brewery. America, fuck yeah, coming again to save the motherfucking day, yeah. This is our tap room. Normally on Friday and Saturday it's open. Also our logistical area, everything that comes in and goes out, we just put it here. And on Friday, 3 o'clock, everything has to get rid of. And then on 4 o'clock, the tap room's open. Let me show you around. So in the sea containers you see over here, all the malts are in. Basic malts on the bottom, specialty malts on top. This is our brew house, 35 hectoliters, 3,500 liters. This year we're probably gonna do 8,000 hectoliters. 4 tanks of 35 hecto, 105 hecto, the middle ones, and 70 hecto at the back. We can brew up to 1 million and hopefully we're gonna reach it in 2021. and we're going to brew a lot of Sabro Session IPA. So we just bought a new canning line. We're just installing it now, checking it. Hopefully we can run at our own equipment now. A bottling line. People are putting bottles on. They're getting washed, they're getting filled, they're getting dried, getting labeled, and then eventually they're getting packed. We also brew the best non-alcoholic IPA of Europe. If you find one, buy it. We now got a stainless steel kegs because we're tired of these plastic ones. It's rubbish. Stainless steel is more sustainable.
Is that the web shop? Can you order beer over there?
No. We don't have a web shop. It's only Beer 52. Beer 52, that's the site you need to go. So this is where the goods are. This is where the good stuff comes from. So outside it's 30 degrees, but here we keep our hops nice and cold because we love Ikema hops. It's 31 degrees outside, so it's time to cool off. It's been a long day. This is how we cool off in Utrecht. Welcome back at the Fenderseek Beach Bar. I'm for the bloopers.
And thank you very much to Vanderstreek for a lovely beer. I'm drinking along and I gotta say, really digging it. Lots of fruit kind of notes coming through. I think you guys are gonna love this one, especially if you're a fan of your hazy IPAs. So we're barreling through the night. We're getting towards the end. The end, the light at the end of the tunnel is in sight. collective awes in the chat, if you will. Press F to pay respects. But we do have plenty more content for you guys left. We've got a whole night's worth of entertainment for you coming up. So with that in mind, we're going to go to our next bit of entertainment, and it is MC Hammersmith.
Clever.
Hello folks, my name's MC Hammersmith. I'm a freestyle rapper from middle class West London. Posh and gangster. Never smoked crack, but I have smoked salmon. Now I take audience suggestions and stories and turn them into improvised hip hop tracks live on stage. The clip I'm going to show you is a clip from the Adelaide Fringe Festival, recorded in February, where I interview a man called Liam, who had a very unfortunate experience in Thailand. Then I turn it into a banger. Enjoy!
Okay, somebody straight off the bat early doors is up for it. Cool, what is your name, my friend? What's your name? Liam, give Liam a round of applause. There we go. Thank you, Liam. Liam, what do you do for a living?
Community development worker.
Wow. Yeah, I was about to say, so specific and yep, so vague. Cool, man. Community development worker. Can you think of something, Liam, mildly embarrassing that's happened to you, either recently or at any point in your life, that you'd be comfortable sharing with the room? So when I say mildly embarrassing, Liam, I'm not looking for something devastating that's going to change the energy. Like when I was younger, I pushed a relative down a well, now they're dead. Not looking for that. Those things change the vibe. What I'm looking for is something mildly embarrassing that you'd be happy to be turned into a success story. For instance, I asked this to a person in Aberdeen a few months ago. He says he went skinny dipping late at night to impress a lady. He went behind a tree, got naked, emerged, and the woman had fucked off. So not a great aesthetic for him. I asked this to another man. He said he flew to Amsterdam, got high and shat himself in a Waffle House. So maybe that's more the vibe we're looking for. Maybe something's gone wrong at work. Maybe a time you got drunk. Anything at all. Liam, is anything coming to mind?
Yes.
Go for it, dude. Go for it.
I was in Thailand.
Where all great stories start. Okay. You're in Thailand.
No, what did you think? I ate some street food.
Yeah. Okay.
I got chronic diarrhea and vomiting, and I had to break into an old grandma's house and use a toilet, and she was very unimpressed.
It's shit and vomiting in the same story. Liam, you hear it, fantastic. I'm gonna ask, and she's had enough of it. She's like, nope, far too fucking gross. Liam, this is a great story. Let's dig deeper. So, you had some dodgy street food. What street food did you have, Liam?
It was sweet, stuffed with pork, mince, and chili.
Who would have thought that would cause rumblings? squid stuffed with pork mince and chili. Fucking never heard of that concoction. Fair play, you're a bold man to try it, and it clearly backfired. Okay, so literally backfired. Yeah, 100%. That was the joke. So Liam is there fucking eating this. When was this, my friend? When was this?
5 years ago,
and still it is on your mind. So it all came out at both ends. You said you broke into an old grandma's house. When you say you broke into, did you literally just run into the first place you could find?
Yes.
You literally broke into someone's house. Cool. I don't know if this is something embarrassing or something we should be arresting you for, to be quite frank. Fucking okay, fantastic. And when you broke in there, why did you choose that house in particular? Cool, so what you did is knocked, immediately gave up on politeness, and then just home invaded. Okay, fair enough. Final question. How long did all this unpleasantness last for?
Hours, but I was hallucinating for a week.
You were hallucinating for a week?
With malnutrition and
okay, what things did you hallucinate? Let's dig deep. What things did you see before you? Yeah.
It's actually the most beautiful experience of my life.
Fucking hell, give Liam a round of applause as he joins me on stage! Jesus, man.
Okay, fair enough. I'm just going to switch a couple of things up here, Liam. So your name's Liam, you do. Remind what you do for a living again? Yes, quality is a bell of love.
Preacher. He's a poet and a preacher.
Say again?
A poet and a preacher.
A poet and a preacher, I see.
Cool, thanks for that. So you're a poet and a preacher. Liam, I'm going to try and turn this into a success story and try and make it something sexy. And given the nature of this, that might be fucking difficult. But I'll do my best. Now, are you from Adelaide, Liam? Are you from Adelaide?
Yes.
Excellent. Would you please hit this button once for me? We'll make it sexy. Cheers.
Liam from Adelaide. Community support officer in all over town. Strictly bitch, you don't play around. Cover much ground. Got game by the pound. Supporting the community is your forte. Each and every day, true play away. He can't let the community out of his mind. While he thinks about support all the time.
Make some noise for Liam, motherfuckers, make some noise. We're about to do this. So, 5 years ago, this man was in Thailand, of all places, where, unfortunately, he ate something, which unfortunately caused things to come out of both ends. And you may be wondering, Liam, how much dignity did you have at the end of this moment? How much dignity did you have?
No.
No dignity, no doubt. And this is a gangster rap about you, Liam. 1, 2, 1, 2. So, people in the place here with no rhyme or reason. This is improvised lyricism right here with Liam. Cause don't you understand, fam, I will be your follower. What do you do? Community support officer. Yes, that is right, fam. That's right, he's a teacher. Well, actually, no, he's a poet and a preacher. And that's the way it happens. Yes, I be rhyming. Where were you? Remind me.
Thailand,
there it is, yeah, this shit is divine. Yo, it's better to rhyme if you pronounce it on time. Now, let me tell you this, yes, he's a dude. What were you eating? Dodgy food. And that's how it happens, yo, these are my thoughts. Cause there was a fucking octopus mixed with some pork. And then something happened, you know I adore it. Once you fucking learn this, join in with the chorus like this.
Home invasion, no dignity. You really fucked it up. Home invasion, no dignity. You really fucked it up. Home invasion, no dignity. You really fucked it up. Home invasion. You really fucked it up.
Now, let me tell you this, man. This is absurd because you were right there. Liam, these are my words. This is how it happens. You know it's quite clear. What happened after this? Diarrhea. Yes, off the top, fam, I'm flying like a comet. These rhymes, they do rocket. Diarrhea mixed with vomit. And you were like, bang, right now I've got the mouse. What did you need to do? Break into someone's house. This is how it happens, yeah. I bust off the top on the door in front of you. Not fucking door. Then a lady approached, and you know it wasn't great. She got closer, then bang, you kicked her in the fucking face. You moved right through. Freestyles are destroyed. You said, sorry, motherfucker, I am there in the toilet. Then you woke up here. Yes, I bust tunes. It's a hallucination. Last time I do fucking mushrooms because
home invasion, no dignity. You really fucked it up. Home invasion, no dignity. You really fucked it up. Home invasion, no dignity. You really fucked it up. Home invasion,
No dignity, you really fucks it up. Liam, 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 Liam. Sing it with me, Liam, 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 Liam. A little bit louder, Liam, 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 Liam. Even louder, Liam, 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 Liam. Now just this side, Liam, 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 Liam. Now just this side, Liam, 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 Liam. Everybody but quieter, Liam, 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 Liam. Now just Liam. Liam, Liam, Liam. Oh, make some fucking noise.
Well done, Liam. Just as we rehearsed. Good man. Give him a humongous round of applause. Fantastic.
Thank you very much to... sorry. It's been a long night. Thank you very much to the guys there. Fantastic. Rich, you have some shout-outs, I believe.
I do not.
Do you not?
Nope. I do. Hang on. So we were in the middle of...
I saw the shout-out train coming your way, Rich.
First shout-out of the evening goes to Edinburgh's Ting Tai Caravan, because we're very much enjoying their curry right now. Excuse me. Woo! Okay, so shout-out to Joe and Rico. Joe has come from Jersey to spend Soberfest 3 with Joe. He also goes by the name Dayman. Ah! Glad someone got it.
Yeah.
shout out from Ellie Chase. Losers have to have a shot. Winners are Ellie, Simon, Ed, Kells, Molly, and Jen. Alekathia? Frida?
Yes,
Alethea. Alethea, excellent. Alethea, shout out to my new husband, Thomas. First Soberfest married, they got impatient and had a quickie on the beach. Which I assume a quickie wedding? Let's just say a quickie wedding. They had a quickie wedding on the beach. Up next... Moving swiftly on, we have a brewery that I am a massive, massive fan of. First time I had this one of these breweries' beers was, it was a good few years ago, and I was fortunate enough to go on a tour around Belgium with Robert from Six Degrees North, fantastic Stonehaven brewery, very much focused on its Belgian beers. And Robert just took me around Belgium, shared so much of his immense knowledge with me. It was a real education. And I think my big discovery of the trip was this brewery, Duranka. Some absolutely sensational beers from bitters to sort of really kind of hardcore Belgian styles. And we're lucky enough to have one of them in the box for you tonight. So... let's find out a little bit more from Durank themselves.
Now, apparently, your beer club is hosting a live-streamed pub quiz in support of breweries during COVID-19. And I applaud that and well done. Now, you'd like me to ask a question. So here is the question. Which is bigger, a puncheon, a hogshead, or a butt? Which is bigger, a puncheon, a hogshead, or a butt?
Hi to everybody at Cyberfest. My name is Casey Wellman, and I'm talking to you from Brauerei Duranka. You're in perhaps one of the most important places at our brewery over here in Dottigny, Belgium. Maybe the calmest place as well. Definitely the best place to be on a hot day like today. This is where we store all of our hops. Sometimes the hops of others too. We don't use any American hops. But what's a bit not quite unique about Duranka in the beer world, but special about us in Belgian Americans, is that we work exclusively with whole hop cones, whole cone hops. We buy them directly from the farm at harvest time, and we keep them all year here in the fridge at 0 degrees. It's always my favorite room to visit. I wish you could smell this place. We use 9 Belgian hop varieties. I believe 2 or 3 are in the Saison de Dauphiné, which we're featuring for our festival. But I thought I would start our tour in this place, also because the lens will probably fog up when I get outside. Let me show you the brewery. So the brewery Duranka has been around since 1996. Started as a project of Nino Bassel and Guido DeVos, just brewing in Nino's garage, actually in Wevelgem, which is about 12 or so kilometers from here. In 2004, they found this lovely space. It's an old textile factory. And they, what they wanted to do is, since the beginning, they wanted to work with whole hops. They wanted to build a brewing system that would work with whole hop flowers, without a whirlpool, but also filtering the hops directly in the kettle. And after consulting with a few suppliers, everybody said no in Belgium because it was complicated. So they had this custom built in 2004. It's a 40 hecto system, so 4,000 liters. That's the mash tun, designed after the form of some old mash tuns. Basically, it's designed after an early 20th century brewing system. And here's our boiling kettle. So they had this baby custom built. The hops always stay in there after the boil. This way, well, first of all, the hops are free in the wort, freely circulating. This allows us to get a nice extraction for the aroma portion of hop additions. And the hops stay free, and they actually are a natural filter for our wort here, so we get clear beer without a later filtration or centrifuge or whirlpool. My colleague Jeroen. Say hi, Jeroen. All right, so let's see if we can find some beer that's alive. So here we have Père Noël bubbling away for Christmas time. I moved to the cellar at Duranka. In our cellar, my all of these treasures. This is also another fridge. Here at Duranka, oh, another batch of Père Noël. We don't pasteurize any of the beers. So in order to get a well-fermented beer, we allow our lagering to take place over the period of about a month. And that way the yeast, this is about 16 degrees in here, has time to slowly continue fermenting all the sugars to get nice clear beer with clear flavors in the end. So this is 1 month's worth of beer. It's also very nice to be in here in the summertime. This room is just to actually keep the barrels cool. This is where a portion of our sour beers at Duranka are slowly maturing, fermenting and maturing. For about 20 years, we've been making sour beers of various types, mostly just cuvée and Creek Duranka. But we're all fans of not just bitter beers and hoppy beers here at Duranka, but sour beers. So we have, for example, Back to Black. Sorry if you can't see there. Or Oud Brown. We've started with a little bit of Lambic type beer here. And our Bassis Cuvée. This is the base of both our Cuvée and Creek. Our Saison. Is inspired by some saisons from around the region, as our brewery's only existed for 25 years. But it's the idea of a traditional saison, so fermented to dryness, or very close to. And we always like to put a little bit of bitterness in our beers. So cheers! Hope you enjoy the beer as well. Oh yeah, I'm gonna finish this one. From me and all the others at Darunka, we hope to see you next year. Or this year digitally, if we can. Cheers.
Which is bigger, a puncheon, a hogshead, or a butt? Here comes the answer. And the answer is a butt. They're all types of cask, and a butt cask holds 500 litres. That's some butt.
Thank you very much to the folks at Darunka. If you are drinking along at home with their video, hope you're enjoying the beer. It looked like a fantastic brew. I have a couple of quiz winners and a shout out to give. Now this quiz winner goes right the way back to near the start of the evening. Nick Bennett was the winner of the Game of Thrones type question. And of course the answers for that were the Black Dinner of 1440 and the Massacre of Glencoe of 1692. Some cheery moments in history for you there. Then we have the answer to the last question, which was a butt cask. Puncheons and hogsheads are also types of cask. A hogshead holds 300 litres, puncheon 450 litres, and a butt holds 500 litres. So the next time someone says they want a buttload of beer, you know exactly how much to give them. And the winner for that one was Rachel Sulek. So well done, Rachel. Please do get in touch, and we'll make sure that your beer gets to you. Now I have the shout-out here. Nick and Adam to their friend Tom Knox, DJ TKET, so DJ Ticket, who loved The Honeycomb, currently blasting out Ed Sheeran's song Drunk, very appropriate. So thank you very much, guys, for joining us for Cyberfest. We still have time for a few more shout-outs. If you want to get them in, email us at cyberfest@beer52.com or tweet us with the hashtag Cyberfest3 or put it in the YouTube comments. Let us know. If you want to get a shout-out, you got to tell us.
I have another one here from Al Dente on Twitter to the one and only Danny Moore. He's a great guy and looking forward to... taking all his money when we play poker in a few weeks. Maybe a shout-out will help him deal with that defeat.
I love a bit of trash talk,
especially around poker.
But yeah, we have another video coming up just now, and we're going to just... I'm just checking my notes here. It is going to be the last beer of the night, guys. Collective awe. We've come this far. We can go only a little bit further. We have one more beer for you guys, and it's from Yankee and Kraut, which has to be one of the best names for a brewery, by the way. I don't know if you agree, Rich.
Oh, God, yeah. And it is run by an American and a German, and... they're lovely people, and they just have this fantastic dynamic. So, yes, good brewery, lovely people, good beer. What more could you ask for?
We're sorry, the number you have dialed is not in service at this time.
Ich schleich mir übers Weiher fade, hab mir für ein Dyer Skater Wanderkarten von und über.
Hi, wir are Asterix and Obelix and this is very wrong. Hi, we are Yankee and Kraut, and this is where we brew our potions. Oh, beers? This is where we brew our beers. Nice to meet you. We got some,
Hi, I'm Brian, the Yankee.
I'm Max, the Kraut.
We've got a couple questions that can get us started off. Background information about us.
So, Brian, why is your brewery named Yankee and Kraut? So, what sort of beer did we brew for Beer52 this time?
Munich by Night.
That sounds awesome.
does sound awesome. It looks really cool. Do you know what it is?
I have no idea. Probably a dark beer.
All right, so back to our questions.
Oh,
what else do we have here?
Let's
see. This is a good one. So, Max, are you just a giant or is Brian a twerp?
Twerp. Well, then, I mean, don't you remember? I fell into the brew house when I was a kid, and you are one of the kids from the movie, like one of the kids get shrunk.
All right. Next question: what kind of beers do you guys make?
Yeah, like all of them, that taste great.
Oh, that's a good
why would we make shitty beer? Like, that's
Yeah, you officially cannot buy any beer from us anymore. Okay. What's your favorite beer that you've made?
My favorite beer that we've made? Oh, that's sort of tough.
It's really tough.
I gotta go with one of the hazy ones.
Okay.
The super hoppy stuff.
Okay, which one?
Demolition Can.
Demolition Can's pretty wicked. Okay, and for the traditional style stuff?
I think that one's it.
Definitely. Definitely. Now, if you guys like Munich style dark beers, this is spot on for you. What else we got there?
Lots of interesting stuff, actually. I'm struggling to choose one right at the moment. Wo zum Teufel bleibt das Bier? Verfucken, kleiner Amerikaner. So, we decided we needed some refreshments. And we could have opened that bottle, but then remembered the tanks are just, 2 meters away. So we got to freshen the tank just because, we can.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Prost.
That's a real treat coming in for you.
So, what do we call that here when we go and try beer from the tank?
Yeah, it's fucking.
Phenomenally delicious.
Yeah. I mean, it's pretty much like the perfect balance between, you got some roasty flavors, but from a stout, for example. But those is like super clean, super lean. Very drinkable. You could drink liters of this, even on a super hot summer's day like today. That's super refreshing beer.
Definitely. Hope you guys enjoyed. Feel free to comment or write us a message on Facebook or anything. You'll like it.
Only if you like it.
Yeah, exactly.
If you don't like it, then you don't. That's true. People always. Usually think about wheat beer or Helles when they think about Bavaria, but it's actually the dark lager that's the original Munich sort of beer. That's the most traditional Munich beer style, actually.
How did we get the idea to start drinking Kraut?
I guess we were super thirsty.
Yeah, we were definitely super thirsty. What is the philosophy of Yankee and Kraut? Only brew what we like to drink.
Yeah, that's
not so bad.
Yeah.
Cyberfest.
Yeah.
Cyberfest,
yeah. Das klingt ja mega schön. So I never mentioned that it's pretty cool that we're included in Cyberfest.
But no shit, Sherlock. What do you think we're doing this for?
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, I guess that's going to be a pretty good festival as far as, online festivals go. This should be fun, I guess. Are you waiting? Okay.
How much I'm getting paid?
Huh?
How much I'm getting paid? To babysit my beer?
Yeah, exactly. Should I get another round?
Yeah, please.
All right, be right back.
What the fuck?
So, can we stop this nonsense now and go get a couple drinks?
Yeah. We'd like to say thanks for having us at Cyberfest this year.
Absolutely. Have a great time. Have a great beer.
Hope you enjoy it.
Yeah, have fun.
Fantastic. Thank you very much to the guys at Yankee and Kraut, aka Asterix and Obelix, I believe somebody in the comments was calling them.
That's the chat.
Yeah, I mean, you know, integral part of my childhood, Asterix and Obelix, so that warmed my heart, so it did. But yeah, we are coming to the very, very end of the first evening of Cyberfest 3. Thank you so much for joining us, guys. We do still have one more act left for you, but we just wanted to take this time to say thank you so much to everyone who's watching and commenting and taking part. Remember, you can still tweet us at hashtag Cyberfest3, at Beer52HQ. You can also send us an email with any shout-out requests, especially if you're going to join us for the weekend. You can get your shout-out in early for tomorrow by emailing cyberfest@beer52.com. If you want to get a memorabilia. If you want to get some memorabilia for tonight, then there's the t-shirt, which you can find down in the description from Merch Tee. It's a Cyberfest 3 t-shirt. Wear it, be the envy of your friends, and of course you can feel good because all the money is going to charity from those t-shirt sales. And of course, if you want some more beer, you can also order from the shop, beer52.com/shop, and use the code CYBER10 to get 10% off. All the beers from tonight will be in that shop. So if you found a particular one that you love, please do order it again. Rich, is there anything else that we can let them in on?
Maybe you've been bought a ticket to tonight's show by a friend or loved one, or you've just decided to do it as a one-off. Beer 52 sends out phenomenal beers every single month, along with a copy of Ferment. Over the next few months, we have some really, really special issues coming up. Next up, we've got New York, which I think starts going out. Starts going out to members tomorrow. Some sensational breweries in that one. Mm-hmm. Following that, 4 weeks later, we have a box of 8, 10 or 12 beers of, it's called the Beer 52 Awards. So our favorite beers and breweries from the past 12 months all gathered together in one really special box. And then following that, we've got Melbourne. All sorts of brilliant adventures for you. We are scouring the world constantly to bring you the very best beers that we can find and the very best stories from the most interesting breweries. So if this is a one-off, consider subscribing. It's honestly a decision that you won't regret.
Yeah, and of course there's one thing that I completely forgot to mention, that if you've been enjoying the chat between myself and Rich, first of all, exquisite taste. Well done.
Yeah.
Secondly,
join our OnlyFans page. It's it's a very exclusive group at the moment. But
very exclusive. So exclusive, doesn't exist. But yeah, if you have been enjoying the chat between myself and Rich, we do a podcast for all the Beer 52 themes. So if you want to hear some more random chat, we do go off on tangents quite a lot, but it's a good time, we've been told. So you can find us at the One for the Road podcast, where all good podcasts are held. We've recently done a few during lockdown, so we've got like a big backlog that we can release for you to listen to. But they follow along with the Beer 52 themes in the boxes. So if you want to kind of know what we're talking about, you best subscribe.
It's all basically all the stories that we didn't dare put in the magazine.
Yeah, and we don't dare do live. But we do have the last act of Cyberfest 3 to come.
Which is a real treat.
But it's so good. There's going to be a song in this musical act that will be in your heads for days. I know, because it's running through my head constantly. It is the wonderful, the amazing NYM.
Hey,
Hope you're having a great day.
You won't see me, please.
got one for running away. I will stay, they can take what they take. I'm a giver, I'm giving today. No mistake, it's the price I will pay. I got one for running away. I will stay, they can take what they take. I'm a giver, I'm giving today.
Beer 52, hope you're enjoying Cyberfest. Lots of love. Mwah!
It's absolutely fantastic stuff from NYM. I told you, you would have it in your head, and I guarantee that you're going to go and listen to that again and again because it's phenomenal. I have the last shout-outs of this evening. We've got Katie Tyson wants to give a shout out to the Rippin' Beer Clan. So shout out to you guys. Hope you've been enjoying the evening. And we also have a shout out here from Adam Wellborn. He says, I'll keep emailing until you mention me. Adam, you can stop emailing. We've got you.
Please, God.
Shout out to my wife, Lorna, for putting up with my drunkenness, my best mate, Matt, and his Zoom buddy, Dom. That's really wholesome, Adam. I'm really glad that you emailed so much to get that through. I hope all of you are having a wonderful evening. Rich.
We also have the result of the Twitter poll, which I know you've all been waiting for with bated breath. So the technical winner is all of the above with a heartwarming, a cockle warming 76.5% of the vote.
Golf clap.
In terms of, yes, indeed. In terms of individual breweries though, the winner tonight is our very generous glass sponsor, though that's got nothing to do with them winning. Seven Brothers with 46.8%. That,
well done, guys.
Honeycomb beer was a real runaway winner. Very, very impressive. So that's basically it. We're at the end of the night, folks. All we've got to do now is just got a bunch of people to thank. So the people in the studio here with me, Fraser, Pavel, Frida, Kinnaird up in Aberdeen. We've got, as I mentioned, Seven Brothers, the glass sponsor. The people at Beer 52 who've put so much work into making all this happen. Callum, our beer buyer, who sourced all these amazing beers for you. Rob, our operations and logistics manager, who made sure that they all got out to everyone's houses on time and properly intact in most cases. Most importantly, the brewers, who put so much effort into making these amazing videos and interviews for us this evening. The entertainment, I think, you know, we've done five of these shows now, and I think the entertainment tonight was absolutely, by far and away, the best that we've had so far. Everyone in the customer service team at Beer 52 as well, you know, taking calls and emails and just making sure everyone's happy and you know, gets what they need. Doug, have I missed anyone?
I think that's pretty much everyone, except for, of course, thank you to yourself, Rich.
And to you, Douglas.
Yeah, well, you know, we have to leave ourselves to the end. remember, guys, if you want to get a T-shirt to commemorate the night, you can go to the link down below. It's Merch Tee, and you can get yourself a Cyberfest 3 T-shirt where the proceeds go to charity, and, of course, you get a lovely T-shirt. You can also buy more of the beers in the Beer 52 shop, beer52.com/shop, code CYBERFEST10 to get 10% off. And remember, you can still tweet about the event. Become like the craft beer nerd you were born to be and start proclaiming the wonders of all these beers that we've had tonight, because
it is your destiny.
Absolutely phenomenal. Let the brewers know. They love to hear positive feedback from you guys, and I'm sure it'll make their evenings. And of course, if you still want to keep the night going, we're probably still going to have a few drinks after the show is done. You can head on over to the Cyber Alley to come join all the Beer 52 guys over on the online bars.
We will see you there.
We will absolutely see you there. But apart from that, I think that's the end of the night. So from everyone here at the Beer 52 offices, I have been Doug.
And I am still Rich.
And this has been Cyberfest 3, the first night. Well done, everybody. Thank you so much.
Catch you later.
Bye.
How was that for you?
It was all right. I mean, we keep calling me Shagrid.
I know, it's kind of hot.
It's a step up from Hagrid, but like, I have a name.
Yeah. Shagrid.